letting this man tell you. Y'all, whenever he tells you something, you never believe him. I don't care what he show you. I don't care how he show it to you. You can make a lie like you can tell a lie. Don't ever trust this cracker. That's why we had to go back over the language and look at what we've been taught versus what is amat. Those watching it, you don't know, amat is what we say, not amen. Again, another transformation of how they made a fool out of us, amat, which is true. Y'all know what? People not getting this very well. Goodness. Is that how you spell it? That close enough. Listen, I don't know nothing about English. Now, I spell it abari. I'm trying to lose it. Amat is true. You just say amat. Isn't that right? When we say your mama, that's different. We say amat. True. We don't say amen. We learn this amen raw. It always referred back to the Egyptology. Just showing you how the Christian church will play. Well, you either going to be disciplined with Latin, which is going to put you back at the Greek, which is going to put you back at Egyptology. This is what we got to break from. This is why people hadn't actually transformed into the people that we should be. The lie they've told us, the manipulation they've done to us is to keep our knowledge suppressed and to keep us oppressed. Our people should be a lot further advanced, and we shouldn't count our advancement according to white people rule. That's the problem we got. We look at advancement if we're at the same or we have the same application or authority as white people. That's the wrong way to look at your evaluation. When you evaluate yourself, you want to do it according to the truth. Y'all hear me? Let's look at 2 Timothy 3:16. That would make sense that Timothy would possibly have a Greek name, seeing his father was Greek and his mother would have been of the Abari. Isn't that right? Timotheus, that they were calling. A lot of things these people have told us have been lies. Let's look at what we use. This is 2 Timothy 3:16. Listen.
All scripture.
Not some. All of the scriptures are given.
By inspiration of Elohim.
Not God. If you're using God, then you're going right back again to that same discipline of Latin and Greek. This is, again, another problem we have. You know what's amazing? Who know where these people gathered at today? They're at the Lincoln Memorial. They're at the Lincoln Memorial today. They plan on being there until after the inauguration to disrupt and cause chant, and they're saying, we won't be moved. You know that's a dumb statement? Especially when you're wrong. Versus we're moving. See, we say things we don't even think we won't be moved. That's your problem. You haven't moved from Christian antics. Another problem you have about going to this place, the Lincoln Memorial. Parthenon. Now, this is Parthenon. Y'all had Pantheon. This is a part. The Lincoln Memorial is actually known as a Parthenon. The reason you want to know about that, because that's what the Greeks established. That means it's the house of a virgin. They look at Athena. This is one of their goddesses. This is who they mimicked it after. Henry Bacon is the man that actually built the place. And he created after the Greeks. See, they have a Pantheon and they have a Parthenon. When you break it down, it actually refers to the house of a virgin. When any crackers ever been a virgin? Everything they go to, and see, this is the problem I told when Dr. King went here to let Lincoln piss on top of his head. They tell you, and I told you before, his story, Abraham Lincoln was known as a homosexual. Why would I build a Parthenon, which would be a house of a virgin, when he's supposed to be a man? And his name after a goddess. Because our people don't pay attention. They don't know. We just follow stuff. And again, you got to look at all these college-educated people. You got to look at all these people with all this information, these people that go into theology school that keep sitting here leading you to this garbage. And this is why our people constantly keep going. I have been an advocate and proponent for the long of not going to them cracker houses asking them for nothing. He never established now when we going to ask these crackers for nothing. Y'all hear me? They gave us this weak discipline of sitting here and we being led by some white people that's leading us the wrong way. These people have never meant us anything for our good. And now you sit here and you go to a place that refers to a goddess, a Greek goddess. Don't even amaze them. How many of y'all took this mythology in college? How many of y'all familiar with, wasn't it Athena? Athena, Greek goddess. Is she true? All lies. That's what myth is, a lie. And yet these people, the Greeks have built this, and now these white Americans, you got to watch and wonder, why would these crackers from Europe come over here and build a Parthenon and a Pantheon? Because they're still under the same discipline. And then they're going to give you your religion because it all comes from the Greek, because the Greeks dominated. And about 430 B.C., and 440 B.C. is when they were believed to have built this. So they was invaded, and they were conquered, and it was torn down. They're in, right now in the works in Greece now trying to go back, and they're trying to restructure this stuff because it's coming down. That's Yahuwah's word. Not one stone left upon another is not going to be thrown down. When they came out, which is amazing, you'll find even when Shaul tried to come along, they told they kept crying for the Diana. Greatest Diana, how all the people, all the Athenians worshipped her. See, this has always been their behavior the whole time we've been with these white people. They have always given you God and goddesses. That's how they gave you Jesus. All these are false semantics they give. They just play games with you. And our people have never been delivered because you're not in any truth. That's what destroys us. Now we're looking at what the book told us. He said now all of the scripture, and according to dictionary definition of scripture, some recorded, written down, was given by the inspiration of Yahuwah, which means he inspired it. And now we're going to look at whether it's a gain to it and is
profitable.
That's what we're looking at. So when you go back and you look at it historically concerning Jesus, where's your profitability in Jesus? When you find out that Jesus was the name of the first slave ship that brought you in the 1700s. Why would you be praying to a slave ship? Why would you be using a Latin name to call on somebody that they told you was a Jew and a Hebrew? So why would you be quoting and speaking Latin? Why would you be speaking? It didn't make sense. He wasn't Greek. That's bad. This is bad. And we found out the man had an inherited name. Couldn't have been Greek. Inheritance is something that's been passed down from the father. Isn't that right? So where are we getting this doctrine from that the father's name was Jesus? When there's no J, there's no E in Abari. It does not make sense. You're still speaking Greek. And then you wonder why you still sitting around these people humiliate you and they're desecrating you because you still trapped over their same damnable doctrine. We're in bad shape. Let's look at the book of Abari. You can go and finish this up right quick, too. Abarim, they're going to call it Hebrew.
And is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in Sadiq, that the Anus of Elohim
may... The Anus, which is the man. You know, a lot of times people look, they say, where y'all reading from? We reading your book. We reading the same book you read in your King James book. We just doing correction to it. And that right, we got to come back and we got to correct what you've been taught. We're not going to change the behavior of the people until we change the mindset of people. Isn't that right? That's why we got to go back and look at scripture. A lot of things you've been told don't make sense. It just don't make sense. They can try to tell you their translation. White people lie. Isn't that right? They just lie. They're historical. They're liars. Their whole book, all that knowledge have been lied, been stolen information. It's just being lied. They lie to their own people. And you got to tell them the truth or you're going to correct. And their whole history been a lie. They'll teach their kids about a great-grandfather, a great-grandfather who's a great warrior, or who was a great soldier who killed and did this. Then they come up all the time, they number liars. The American sniper ain't no more false than everything else they got. They always been liars. How in the hell he gonna be a hero to some Afghanistan, to some Iraqis? He no more all the Iraq, a sniper. We ain't here, y'all got people in the military. Ex-military. How many, give me the name of any snipers y'all knew. How the hell some Iraqis gonna know a sniper name? See, people don't even think, they have no idea how much white people lie. How would the Iraqis know the sniper name? From the Navy SEAL. They tell these people anything, make a fool out of them. And they just happen to know that the sniper from Iraq was in the Olympics. I got people here who was in Iraq, Afghanistan. How many snipers y'all knew? Heard of and knew their name from Iraq. They were Iraqi. Why would they tell you that? Why they post this on YouTube, Snapchat, Facebook? Hey, I'm a sniper in Iraq and I went in the Olympics. These people have always lied. They let this man say he lie. His family never lie. paid him, gave him medals and honors, and the whole time, I called it before the information came out. Never seen it, had never knew that. I told y'all he was a liar. They always lie. They give you a medal, hell, if you 900 miles away from an explosion. And the ground rumble. They've been, and you know what the thing is, people laugh about black people getting medals. They've always been giving white people medals for nothing. Oh, a couple of black ones got said that white people always got them. Medals for bravery and never even been nowhere. They've always lied to you. I don't know. That's the problem you got to look at. They've never stopped lying from the religion to even historical facts. They have always been liars. They don't tell you that, but they keep it recorded, and that's coming up. And Malcolm told him his chickens coming home to roost, which didn't make sense because chickens don't roost. Roosters do. See, Cracker was looking at him too. So you heard chicken roosting. We talked about all scripture. It's given by the inspiration of Al-Ahim, not God, not El. We don't use El. Al-Ahim, which means, brother, the mighty one. So if you start talking like this, see, crackers look at you differently. When you start saying God and Jesus and Lord and all these other terminology, then crackers know you're still under psychosis of foolishness. See, we got to show these white people we're awakening. We owe this to ourselves and to our children a better future. We can't afford for one more so-called black Negro man or woman to die in some more false illusion. When we come back to look and our eyes come illuminated to the truth, start cutting our beards off, start shaving our head, bald head, so we can try to look like these crackers and come back to where they're established for, our information come back to us. They say I become radical because my antennas are on now. As long as you stay clean, shaven, that's why they folk get you on these jaw. Don't want no hair in your face, so they can make sure you get absolutely no reception. That's why people can't pay attention to what I'm telling them. They're too caught up in their lives to keep saying, Mama was Jesus, Daddy was Jesus, Granddad, that's all I know in Jesus. You know a whole lot of things. If it's wrong, you need to delete the information. Y'all hear me? Why did Elohim see fit to allow me to get the opportunity to chat to hear the truth? I'm just grateful. Every one of us, people going through here, this ain't the first time information has come through. It's not the first time. It's just the mere fact that what are you willing to do when you hear the truth? Are you willing to make transformation conform? Because at the end of the day, all we can look at is what's recorded. What I believe can't be different than what's been recorded. What's been recorded being scripture. This is facts. Now, some have been played with, but I got to get back to what's fact. This is what keep me grounded. If he told me that all that was given by him, then I got to look at what did he give. Then he told me it's profitable, but then I got to start looking at that's where I'm going to get my gain at. I got to start looking at this is my instruction. If I'm going to be right, if they're going to call it, which is Sadiq in our language, then I got to make sure I stay with the scripture. If I'm going to get to where I'm going to be blank, that the man of Elohim might be what? Perfect. Blameless. Only way you're going to do that is with the scriptures. Look at the 17th chapter. You hold what you got here. 17th chapter book of Barashit. They're going to call it Genesis. But the correct name is Barashit. So you need to know this. They're like, this is just too much work. And you look at how much work you're doing to go to hell. 17:1. Other one you're going to get me by the sheet. By the sheet 14:1. 14:14. Give me 14:14 first. They call it Genesis. That's not the correct name. Again, Genesis is something else Greek. The reason why you got to dispel this is because then you got to start looking at how everybody has played with you the whole time you've been giving stuff. Everything you've been told, people have been playing. The preachers, they program, they teach, and they educate them to play games with you. Barashit, chapter 14, verse 14. Listen.
And when Abram heard that his Aki was taken captive.
Listen what happened. When Abram, which would mean what? His name means exalted, exalted father. Abram, R-A-M, means exalted. That's what he was, Abram. He was exalted father. Now, when he heard that his Aki, which is our word for brother, did what?
Was taken captive.
When he heard it was taken captive, look how he prayed and waited on God and called on Jesus. Listen.
He armed his trained servants.
He said, we Christian. We can't be taking up no weapon. We just got to wait on the Lord. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
He armed his trained servants.
I wonder where he got the weapons from. Well, I wonder where he get them, stones? Well, I wonder where he got, they probably were prayer warriors. You don't see them prayer warriors. Them people going on their knees just be calling on Jesus. Starving, they probably were prayer warriors. That's what the man did. Let's pay attention to what the man did. The man armed his trained servant, which means they had technique. They had tactical training. Armed his trained servants. They were taught how to fight. Hold you, God. Give me Beth Shumawal 1 and 18. Make it 1 and 14. They're going to call it 2 Samuel. Beth Shumawal 1 and 14, we'll read down. Beth means second. That's when I abari Allah Beth. Listen.
And Daoud said unto him.
And Daoud, not David. Listen.
How wast thou not afraid to stretch forth thine hand to destroy Yahuwah's anointed?
I tried to tell you about that last night, didn't I? He want to know about that. That's what people are not afraid of. And this is what we had to invoke. We got to get invoked back into these people that's killing us and murdering us and massacring us. We can't keep continuing to gather ourselves in a building and then rehearse over lies and hypocrisy. He wanted to know something. How was it you weren't afraid to kill Yahuwah's anointed? What happened, son?
And Daoud called one of the young Anus and said.
He called one of the young men and said.
Go near and fall upon him.
You know what he done? I want you to go and kill him. He killed Yahuwah's anointed. He said, I want you to go. I want you to fall and I want you to kill him. What happened?
And he smote him that he died.
You said he prayed.
And he smote him that he died.
I don't know what we've been taught. Now, here's a man we find. Hold you, God. I want to find out something about him first of all. See the 13th chapter of the book of Acts of the Apostles. Let me just find out something because I might be wrong. Let me see something. See what 20 say. We kind of look all over the place, don't we? But I guarantee it's right. Listen.
And after that, he gave unto them Shaphatim about the space of 450 years.
Y'all see what now? What you find here, you find Shaul just going over some historical facts. After they had these different things, he said, you'll find now. He gave them Shaphatim, which they're going to call judges. For how long?
About the space of 450 years.
Listen what happened.
Until Shamu'al the Nabah.
See that? Until Shamu'al
the Nabah.
Come on.
And afterward they desired a Malak. And Elohim gave unto them Shaul.
But oh, they're looking for them. We don't have prophets. Again, prophets are people that soothsay for God. It's Nabah. Listen.
And afterward they desired a Malak. And Elohim gave unto them Shaul,
see, the ben of Cis. After this, they desired to have an emperor. They desired to have a ruler. So he gave them Shaul. Listen.
And Anus of the tribe of Benjamin.
Listen.
By the space of 40 years.
Listen.
And when he had removed him, he raised up unto them Daoud to be their Malak.
See what he did? He raised up for them Daoud to be their Malak. Listen what happened.
To whom also he gave testimony.
And
said,
Hold on for a minute. What happened now?
To whom also he gave testimony.
He gave a testimony? What did he say?
And said,
what did he say?
I have found Daoud.
You found who now?
Daoud.
What about him?
The ben of Jesse.
Yes.
And a noose after mine own heart, which shall fulfill all my will.
I'm just going with what he said. He said, I found him. So this man here going to fulfill all my will. He after my own heart. He looked at somebody killed his anointed. It's only right that you die. I know they think this is radical teaching and this is crazy and whatever. But these crackers teaching it to their kids. And they teaching their kids to kill the anointed. See, when he looked at his people being slaughtered, his people being killed, he looked at, there's no way in the world this should continue to happen. I got a man I'll find that'll sit here and he'll exercise all my will. Huh? He said, that's a man after my own heart. He said, I really like this guy. When he heard how Shaul had died and how he found that man sitting and suffering and how he had sat and took a sword and killed him, well, you just pronounced your own death. How was it you weren't afraid to kill Yahuwah's anointed? But we don't look at stuff like that, do we? I know. It's different. It's a different time. Now, this is crazy. This is what I tell y'all. They say in desperate times, we are the only people that's out on the street that can be pulled over and gunned down at any time. On film. With witnesses and nothing be done. We're the only people that's sitting here and being trapped and put in places and being held back from a lot of our prosperity. We're the only people that have been robbed of our knowledge, our information, of our land, of our goods. We're the only people. Everybody that got goods have taken it from us. We had orders from Elohim to take their goods from them. Because all these people are idolaters. Isn't that right? They were worshiping idol God. We took their stuff and we brought it into Elohim's temple. Now these false God worshipers are coming and taking the goods back from us. Now we're going to do just like Abraham did. Come on back at the 14th chapter. You can't afford to keep sitting down being taught to be passive. At what expense? This is at the expense of our lives every day. You got black people sitting out here sitting right up under Abraham Lincoln's piss in the house of Arthur, the pagan god, and they don't even know where they are. These so-called religious leaders lead these people to damnation and destruction. And our people are dying every day. El Shaddai is getting paid to lead these people to this idol god. All those people say, all the people ain't getting paid are the suckers that paid for them tickets that drove up there and flew up there and caught buses up there. Them fools ain't, they'll have no idea they're being led like sheep to the slaughter. Here it is Shabbat. These folks be stopping doing what they're doing. They should be honoring Elohim. They should be taking his knowledge and his information. And the sad part, like Pharaoh, they led away our men with false information and false premises of hope. What did that million man march ever yield us? Nothing. If they were men, they'll be taking care of their home. They'll be providing. If they were men, they'll be fearing Elohim and keeping his law, statute, and judgment, and commandment. Our young men ain't even got nobody to look to. There ain't no standard being set for them. And our women even worse work. It ain't a worse situation. Listen.
And when Abram heard that his Aki was taken captive.
And when Abraham heard his Aki was taken captive. Tell him how he prayed, son.
He armed his trained servants.
And what happened?
Born in his own house.
What did he do?
318.
What are they telling you? That's how close we are. Everybody he considered to be a servant to him was somebody born in his house. Couldn't trust the outside. We the only people trust everybody outside. See, these white folks try to set you up. You don't realize how close-knit they clan stay and how white people keep stuck. They learn from your book how you were at one time. One time you were invincible. You were invincible because you kept your knowledge, your information, and your people to themselves. But you wanted to go and you wanted to mix with them. That's how they came up and gave you the name Abyssinia. That's what the Arabians call you. Abyssinia. You were taught this. Abyssinia. Because they say you was a mixed race. That's what the Arab, this is what these people call you, Abyssinia. They believe you are mixed race. You are mixed. That's why you got so many different shades of color. Huh? When you were Ethiopians, you had a burnt face. But now these people done came in and they mixed you. And you know when they mixed you, they also mixed you and they mixed you up. When you got mixed, you also can be mixed up. That's why so many of our people throw people, I don't know what to believe. I don't know what to do. I'm hearing so many different things. That came in with part of you being mixed up. You're so mixed up, you got so many different other things working in you, going at you to try to keep you away from hearing and adhering to truth. What else you going to do? It's easier for you to hold to what you know. That's why people stay with Sunday worship. People stay with Jesus. People stay with God. Even when they hear it's wrong, even when you can get them definitive proof that they're going the wrong way, they're going to look at what's comfortable. That's what I know. It fits on. That's what my mama know. That's what my dad know. That's what my grandmama know. That's what everybody I know. That's what everybody else saying. That's why everybody else going to hell. At the 7th chapter, book of Matthew. Because what people said, what's scaring me, I hear y'all saying, but I don't hear other people saying it. Y'all the only people saying it. It ain't enough people saying it. If it was right, why everybody don't know it? People don't want to know. Other way, you give me Matayahu chapter 11, verse 25. You give me this Matayahu 7 and 13. This is what he told you.
Enter ye in at the straight gate.
The problem going to become with that, they got to know how to get to the gate. Yehukanan 644. You know what they don't get? They ain't got a lot of people can put their information down where you can go behind them and research it. They don't care. You just been sitting around being led and dumbfounded with a book. You have absolutely no idea what you're doing. The name is Yehukanan, not John. Now he just told you to enter ye in at the straight gate. Let's see what he told you. Yehukanan 6:44. Listen.
No Anus can come to me.
Which is no man can come to me.
Except the Abba which have sent me draw him.
So the first problem that come with this statement right here, Leon. What did they tell him again to do, Brandon? 7:13? Oh, who had it? Oh, you had both of them.
So enter ye in at the straight gate.
Which means Brandon must be on vacation. The rook and the bishop were one and the same. Listen.
Enter ye in at the straight gate.
Well, the problem going to become with that is you can't get that except he draw you. Oh, anybody can hear this. Enter ye in at the straight gate, but then tell them, ask them to explain you, where's the gate? Huh? Hoes you got? Yes, Yahoo. Yahoo 6:16. Yahrum Yahoo, they're going to call it Jeremiah. See, I just want to show you just how difficult things really are for people, and they just don't know it. They just don't know it is. Yahrum Yahoo 6:16. Again, we talked about the ram exalted, because that's what Yahrum Yahoo means, not Jeremiah. It means Yahuwah exalted. When was Yahuwah exalted? When Yahushua was on the tube. So this will give him the name Yahrum Yahoo. See, these people have no idea why statements were being made. This makes sense, doesn't it? He would be who? Yahrum Yahoo. When was he Yahrum Yahoo? When he was on the tube. Let's look at something. Listen.
Thus saith Yahuwah.
Thus saith Yahuwah.
Stand ye in the ways
and do what? And see, which means the The oom for the eye. Take sight. See, they don't realize how important all this stuff is. Eyesight. So now he just told you to stand ye in the
ways,
which is plural, and do what?
See.
Explain me, how am I going to see without a oom? How can I have sight without the oom? Kazoom, chapter 3. See, the reason why I got to keep doing this, see, I'm going to get you to a perfect standing. That's what they don't have. That's all I got to do is in again at the straight gate. First of all, you idiot, you don't even know how to find the gate. There are a couple of things you're going to need in order for this to happen. Kazoom, chapter 3, verse 16. Make it 17. Make it 18. Kazoom 3:17. Listen.
Because thou sayest,
I'm what?
Rich.
And have what?
Increased with goods.
Yes.
And have need of nothing.
And what happened?
Knowest not that thou art wretched.
They don't have, you know what? Education has been one of the biggest falls of our people. Education and accumulating things. He said, because you said I'm rich and I have need of nothing. And what happened?
And knowest not that thou art wretched.
And what else?
Miserable.
And what else?
Poor.
And what else?
Blind.
And what else?
Ara.
See, now you telling me, don't use Ara yet. We're going to go back to naked. Until, just go back to naked. Because he just told you to do something. Stand ye in the ways and do what? You know the problem going to become him. If your mindset is you already good, you already can see, you already know, this is not going to help you. So first of all, we need to look at what is your estate. What is your present day estate? Y'all got me? This is how important it is for us to really set back to look at. You just can't take this and run because you're going to make a mess. Make sure we understand exactly so you can understand and overstand exactly where you're at. First of all, look at what you're saying. You're good. You know, I listen, but you know, and you don't have no need. You broke. You're poor, you're blind, and you're naked. That's what he told you to do.
I counsel thee.
See, I'm giving you a recommendation for a course of behavior. To do what?
Buy of me.
Buy of me what?
Gold.
Try
in the fire.
So thou
mayest be rich.
And tell me what else I'm going to have.
White raiment.
And what has happened?
That thou mayest be clothed.
See that? So now he's trying to change my... This is the first thing I have. First of all, I got to change. Don't do this until there's change. If I don't change, Chanel, I don't care what I see. It's going to be wrong. This is the problem we have with people today that try to come into religious institution. You're trying to do something and there's no change. You're thinking you're good and the whole time you're not good. So this is not going to benefit you until I fix this first. This is what he told you. First of all, now you're going to be rich. You need to purchase from me. This is why the book told you to buy the, what was it? A mod. And do what? Sell it not. Don't get rid of it. You know the problem is? A lot of people done gave it away. That's the first thing I need to do. I need to get you to purchase something. Even they give you the definition or give you the description for what they were so-called a deacon, which makes no sense because we don't have a deacon. Again, this is Greek deaconess. This would be a minister. It makes no sense. He told they're going to purchase to who? Themselves. I mean, they bought the truth. They bought a mot. Sell it not. Don't get rid of it. If you've used this offer, he said you're going to purchase to yourself, which means you're going to take possession of something. That's what I'm trying to get you to do. When you buy something, you take possession of it. And don't get rid of it. Now, this is what he said. Now, we're talking about you changing your clothes. You thinking you have on something you're not. Who do we learn it from? We learned it from Adam. Adam and his wife, when they found out they were naked, they said their eyes were what? But the book, they were blind because they assumed what they had on was appropriate. But later we found he said he made them aprons. So I'm trying to show you, you don't even know how to dress yourself. See, this statement doesn't make sense if I don't know the law. They assumed they were dressed. They assumed they could see it and didn't even know they were blind. When they said their eyes were open, they were blind. They had to be blind because he said, I came to open the blind eyes. They don't make sense. I came to open the eyes of somebody that can see. He said, but because you think you see, your sin remains. That's why these people not traveling, because you thinking you know something, you don't know it. That's why your whole life is unraveling right before you, because you don't know what you think you know. You don't. What you believe has been wrong, and then you got to transform. You know, it's hard. I'm thinking I'm doing good. I'm thinking I got money. I'm sitting here. And the man said, man, you don't even know you broke. Broke? That's stupid. I got money. No, what's stupid is what you're thinking. You're broke. And I'm thinking I got on cold. You're naked. I'm thinking, I feel like I'm a pretty good person. He said, you're wretched. Hold on for a minute now. I think I would see if I was wretched. And you blind. So what do I need to do? I'm giving you recommendation. I need you to buy from me so you can be rich, so you can put on some clothes, so the shame of your neck and it doth not appear. And listen, what else he going to do?
Anoint thine eyes.
With who?
Eye salve.
That thou may what?
See.
Now we can come and look at this. Yahoo 6:16. Now let's come here. See, this, you know what the problem is? People start going somewhere you don't need to go. Get here. To get here, first of all, let's clean up your situation. Yahoo 6:16. Listen.
Thus saith Yahuwah.
Thus saith Yahuwah.
Stand ye in the ways.
And do what?
See.
And do what, son?
And ask for the old path.
Where's the what?
Taub way.
And what happened?
Walk therein.
And what happened?
And ye shall find rest for your souls.
Not if I think I already got it. Not if I feel like I'm already good. Not if I think I already see a way that's right. Marsha Lee. They're going to call it Proverbs. Marsha Lee means by word or adage. These are by words. Listen, your book told you were going to be called that. In Aleph Malachim, the 9th chapter, he said you were going to be called a Marshallee. That's what they're using now. Huh? Nigga tell everything. They got all kind of byword. They call it Proverbs, but it's actually a Marshallee. Byword. That's what they use about you now. You don't even realize everything he told you was coming to pass. It's coming to pass. Listen, Marshallee 12:14. Listen.
Verse 15.
Verse 15?
Yes, sir.
Well, let's hear 14. Read it down.
And Anus shall be satisfied with Tou by the fruit of his mouth.
Listen.
And the recompense of an Anus hand shall be rendered unto him.
See that? You're going to get it right back to you. And the book told you to be not marred. He told you Elohim and not marred. Whatsoever man sow. Go out there and pluck okra and see if you get tomato. Okra coming back up. Whatever man sow, he going to reap that. Why you think when we read in the book of Belshumal 1:14, the man told you what he did to Shaul. He pierced him through with his sword. You heard what Daoud said. That's the same thing you just read. He got a recompense right back from his hand what he did. You just killed Yahuwah's anointed. What you think was going to happen to you? It will come in right back to you. Okay, don't worry about it. Did Marshall, did my word right? Listen.
The way of a fool is right in his own eyes.
Yeah.
But he that hearkeneth unto counsel is wise.
14 and 12. Marshall 14 and 12. And that's the problem you got right now. People sitting around there a fool, and they look right, and the only problem it is in your own eye. That's why I told you you're blind. The difference you'll find with Yahuwah, the man of, we'll say, the Anus. Most people don't know they hear we're saying Anus. People think we're creator. And of course it's strange. It's real strange to hear this because of the fact that you're hearing something you never heard before. It's Anus, which would mean man or men as plural. Anus is the actual pronunciation, not man. He made Anus. But a lot of time our people don't know that when you hear it, and they're saying, like, it's so much I got to learn. Look at how long they take. When you go to these schools, they call them, these are actually institutions. They're institutions, the same thing they call prisons. Huh? And prisons are used to what they call so-called rehabilitate people, actually go and establish people, make people. It don't change them to transform them to come out. Very few people go through that system and come out and make a real change. A lot of time it teach them to be in a, continue to stay in an institutional state. Because most of the time people keep going back, it's repetitive. You learn how to survive. It's a system. Y'all got the same thing they do with the education system. People come out from these schools and need education, need college. All they get is a job. Show me how many colleges you teach these people how to create. They're like prison. That's what they teach you to do. And a lot of times we don't even realize that. At the end of the day, these people, you pay somebody to make a fool out of you to teach you how to go get a job. You can learn how to, that's easy to go and do. All you do is find somebody that's saying help on it. Go and apply. And now you meet the qualifications, you get it. You pay somebody going to teach you how to get a job, which means you have no survival skill. That's what a slave did. You learn how to get out there and stay out of master's face and make sure you don't make master mad so master don't kill you and master don't get rid of your kids and so master give you somewhere to stay. You know what happened after the so-called the lie or the hypocrisy of abolishment of slavery, which had never happened? It's a lie for you to even go and repeat the slavery in it. You're still a slave. You had to. You know what the book told you? The borrower is serving to the lender. So you are still a slave because you're working to pay the debt. What they did to a slave will make him pay the debt of what they paid to buy him from purchase. Niggas don't know nothing. Telling them lie, you run around repeating stuff. White crackers look at you and laugh at you, you dumb nigga. Because you say stuff, you don't even know what you're saying. Only thing you learn how to do is to get out here and survive on a plantation. Do you know after the so-called hypocrisy of abolishment of slavery that most people stay on the plantation? They had never been, they never forget most of you, and you lose your job. You know the first thing you do? You damn apply for another one. What mean you look for another master that you can set your ass down on and work.
That's right.
And let him give you what he want and let y'all when he get ready. Made you want his day, his Christmas, his Thanksgiving, his Easter, his 4th of July. Slave looked forward to getting them days. He made you work. You had to keep them like he kept them. Hell, for Christmas, you were getting your kid fruit. Crackers get their kids another nigga. Don't get mad because I said niggas because I know you're too stupid. I love niggas. Niggas. Emperor. He knew it. He couldn't pronunciate when he saw us. We're emperors. He hate when you use it. You know when they try to get you away from these so-called Negro leaders? Because they trying to keep you away from it. Because you keep saying, they keep saying, white people, and they say, what did you say? Hey, what's up, my nigga? What's up, diamond nigga? All right, nigga been chilling, man. What's been done, nigga? White folks, they say, what it is you say, y'all say, y'all, I thought y'all shouldn't use that word. And they got you fighting them. cracker called me nigga. Why I'm getting upset because a cracker called me emperor? He know me. Say, so you know me, white boy. That'll mess him up every time. Okay. That's amazing. Because Mexican call themselves niggas. Do you know other races call themselves niggas now? Yeah. And white people call each other niggas. Yeah. You be sitting around saying, they call themselves niggas. Because he taught, listen, he lies. He gave you a word and he created a definition. He put it in a book, hell, and called himself Webster, and you believed it. Hell, if I say my name Webster and I write down a definition, you going to believe me? Where did I get the definition? I created the word. You look through a book called a dictionary. Hell, a white man wrote it, and he wrote some definitions, and your ass run out here spreading it out to people like you know something. How you going to beat me telling me what I done sat here and taught you that lies? You a dummy. The word originated from niggas. This word came from us when we were in Ethiopia. Before they were called Ethiopia, they were Ethiopes from the land of Cush. That's what we were called after the domination. They called themselves niggas. They were named after Francis Niggas, Colonel Francis Niggas. They don't tell you nothing. That's where it came from. He was a ruler. Then you sat here and the white man seen you, he was calling you niggas. When he got you baby, he would call you niggas. Then you heard him say he called nigger, negros. He would call you nigger. You try to figure why he said nigra. Then he had to sit here, he tried to demote you with the terminology. You so damn stupid, you running from it. Got a casket, marching with music, gonna bury nigga. That's all this cracker been doing is burying you. Yep. Hell, he done buried you in his library. It's a place where he tell lies. Yep. It's a library. You like, you so dumb, your mama dumb. Yep. It's a library, it's a place where he hide lies. Yep. He got the truth buried. Why you think they put nigga in the ground? I ain't gonna use that word no more. Cracker like good. Because I told you it's a derogatory word. I told you ass is a derogatory word, but that's what I name a donkey. A ass. Now, which one is it? That's amazing. Today, Department of Justice came out to condemn Chicago Police Department. You ain't gonna believe what they just said. They got damning evidence. That was the headline in bold letter, damning evidence. I wonder who's going to go tell them they were cussing. Because damn means condemn. You build a dam to stop something up. So you say, stop it, damn it. You can't be smart, man. You give me your money. These people manipulate you. They manipulated you so long you never had original thought in your life. Everything you thought and everything you judged have been through that cracker eye. That's why he told you, I got to anoint your eye with eyesalve you can see. You can't see properly, judge nothing. How you going to pick the right way? You know what you're going to go with right here? What feel good. Huh? I feel good, good. Y'all remember that song? I feel good. Come on, put your hand together. Good, good. Every time I think about who? Jesus. I feel that cracker gave you that. Every time I think about a slave ship, that's what I just said. Every time I think of an earth pig, I feel good. So what's wrong with me? Then you know what you need. You need some counsel. What's a recommendation for behavior? See, when I anoint your eyesalve, I anoint your eyes with eyesalve so you can see. That was Yahushua made for the man eye. He made some eyesalve so he could see. I could teach y'all something about that. Y'all don't know. They ain't ready for it. They couldn't take it. I tell you, I can show you something. You don't know. You think you know. You don't know, though. I know you don't know because they ain't told you. And he ain't just going to give it to you. He crack a lot of you so much, they make a fool out of you too many times. You just don't know they make a fool out of you. See, I'm trying to get us back to where we need. When he told you to stand in the ways and see, ask for the old path, which means ask for the old path. I'm sitting here looking all these ways. Well, all of them look good, Brandon. Let me ask you a question. Which one of them been here the longest? Because he told me to ask for the old path. Because you going to, guess what happened? In the book told you in 2 Timothy 3:16, 2 Timothy 3, give me 3 and see if about 6. I need y'all attention. Because I'm telling you, when you really start, every one of our people should be angered. What gets me mad is when I don't see our people become angered enough to make transition. See, if you're really angry, you transition. You don't keep staying in your same state. They pay you just enough that you can't create. They pay you just enough where you keep coming back. You can't. You're like a slave. You never give a slave money. You give him a shanty. You don't give him too much. You give him too much, he's going to want more. You teach a slave how to live best he can with the little he got. You don't teach them. They don't even realize that. Hell, you're on your knee praying. Lord, I thank you, Jesus, for my journey. I'm in hell. Whoa, you brought me from a mighty long way. In hell, kids top packed on top of each other. Crocker house, 10 store, ain't got but two damn pieces of kid in there. I'm in a one-room shanty, a shit house, Tim. If they would have told you to go outside and piss, you wind up pissing in my house that's so small. You can tell one from the other. And I'm in here praising God and Jesus for this little piece of shit, Tim. I doubled it up. Why that cracker didn't never have no shanty? This cracker still, his house is still standing. Your shanties are torn down. Well, no, yours still standing too. You remember an apartment that got you stacked off in rooms. All apartment is a room. Hell, a room with some dividers in it. This cracker still got these old standing plantation houses. You still going, your house ain't bigger than that. It wasn't nobody but him and two kids. You study praising God. He praising him too. Thank you, Jesus. And you be so kind and send me some more niggas next week. And this is part of the damning psychology they've done to us, and it has to be broken. That's what he was looking at here, because you're assuming you're okay and you're not okay with just pieces and bits of stuff versus you getting the whole truth. Come on.
For of this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women.
Bang, maybe give me about five. Listen.
Having a form of
Allah. That's what I want. Might make it 3-1. That'd be fine. 3-1. 2 Timothy 3:1. Let's see what he said.
This know also that in the last Yamim.
Tell me, that's what we at now. They'll call it days. It's actually called Yamim. That's why he'll find his name is Ben, which means, could his name possibly mean son of my right hand versus son of my days? Another lie they told him. Ben Yamin, which will make him son of my days. He was Ben Yamin. He told you he possessed me in the beginning of his ways. I was brought forth from everlasting. He was trying to tell you who he was the whole time. I'm Ben Yamin. This is the son of my days. Don't worry about it. Keep listening to what Crocker said. None of it had no meaning. Hell, go look up George Washington. A white man, most of these people don't even know this Crocker was considered one of the harshest slave owners. And you know they'll tell you a lie that George Washington actually opposed, him and Thomas Jefferson actually opposed slavery. Oh, they got it in writing. See, that's in the library. But when you actually look it up, he was one of the most you know it bad when other crackers that own slaves have a problem with you? First of all, your plantation has so much distance between it, the slaves never knew each other. How the hell they know how you treating your slaves? This man will have his slave master to pull the teeth out of slaves' mouth, and he will put them in his mouth. That's how nasty that cracker was, and they told you he had wooden teeth. He was so cruel, he would get them, and he would ship his slaves out to the West Indies. That's how far. He wouldn't just send you to another plantation. George Washington would send your ass to the West Indies. That's how far Disney. Y'all don't know nothing about these crackers. Y'all don't know nothing about them. Calvin Coolidge was a homosexual. First single president they ever had. Y'all didn't even know that. All your presidents will tell you how to be married. Coolidge wasn't. And Coolidge was a known homosexual. Clayton Bishop, hey, a homosexual. He said, ain't nothing wrong with grace. Something wrong with Will. Something wrong with Calvin Coolidge. He was a homosexual. And they'll tell you he's the father of your country. That's why there's no problem with them putting a man at a Parthenon, which is for a female. Got it. Because I told y'all before, the man was gay. Now, if he done did all this lying, what else could he possibly lie about? That's why you had to go back and you got to reexamine everything he told you now. Now, he just told you now, knowing this in the last day, what's going to happen, son?
Perilous times shall come.
Danger. Look at, let me ask you something. These are the last y'all mean. Who they killing and gunning down when they pulling over? Unarmed, on tape, on YouTube. Like bitches said, and they posted on YouTube. You can't even get a conviction off these dirty crackers. They tell you to wait. Let justice work. How the hell these three kids in Chicago already been convicted?
That's right.
They don't tell, we don't need no deliberation. I got the rope right here. Them kids are already guilty. Where you gonna find a jury that gonna sit down and judge these kids and say they're not familiar with the case? They hadn't already had some impression been put in their mind for these crackers. Cause you seen something on tape. You don't even your book tell you to hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Why you gotta hear the whole conclusion when these crackers gunning you down? You don't know what that white boy did that led up to that situation. Even I judged it prematurely just looking at it. But now since I thought it over, let me get all the evidence. Let me examine it and get with my people and get back with you guys and I'll give you a conclusion. Because there's a lot of missing links in that story. I ain't seen no piss dripping out of his mouth, so I don't know if he drunk out no toilet. Hell, him and his people, that ain't nowhere he ain't used to being. I ain't seen him look unhappy. Hell, he look normal. Y'all all right? Hell, I know tearing their clothes up couldn't have done nothing to him. Hell, they were barbarians when we met them, and that's historical fact. They were Aryans. Those people came down and invaded up from the north side of the mountain. They were barbarians. So his clothes being tore up don't mean nothing to him. Hell, he a lunatic. Okay. Got to go back. I got to reexamine everything. Don't get mad at me. I'm going back to my culture, my history. So he going back to his too. I want to go back to my father's house. Hell, he want to go back to the cave. Y'all all right? Hell, look at Batman. Sure, he was a damn Aryan. Bastard live in a mansion. Everything. Hell, he did more time in the cave than he did in the house. Hell, I'm going to be down there, bats flying all around me in the cave. I can carry my ass upstairs somewhere. Hell, Albert will bring me some more Cocoa Puffs or something. Hell, I'm down with spiders and damn rats running all around me. They're just quiet and just happy. All kind of shit flying by you. Just, Tim. Y'all ain't going to make me say I said something I ain't say. I ain't putting my foot on Eddie Murphy's cop. Y'all put my foot on Eddie Murphy's cap. What did that show you about white people? They really didn't get you a move, get you excited about a crocodile down here in the bay, down here with all these damn spiders and stuff running around. Bats in a cave. What is this? Fascination. Gotta watch these people. Come on, son, finish this up.
For a noose shall be lovers of their own selves.
Y'all hear that? Lovers of their own selves. You don't think we see that with them? They introduce all that homosexual stuff on us. Don't let these folk make no fool out. Yeah, we had them among our people. Don't play like we didn't. We did. But our law was always to kill them. That was our law. I'm not going to sit here and lie. Yeah, we done had homosexual among us, even with Sodom and Gomorrah, but our law was to kill them. Our law wasn't to give them no damn rights to protect them. That's against nature. Anytime you find these behaviors against nature, you take it down because you're going against nature. You're going against the ordinance of Elohim. I'm going to no protect the law of no homosexuality. It need to be stopped. You can't reproduce from it. You ain't got no business doing it. No good word he told you, women with women, men with men, working that which is unseemly. When you find a homosexual, Elohim gave you over to that fool to dishonor yourself. Get no protect the law. Get no foolishness like that. We got to save our men and our women. That's what we got when we mixed in with this inbreeder. This man is a virus. And he killing our people. That's how we got cancer and black and got high blood pressure and got all these other diseases because we done mixed in with this virus. None of these diseases weren't heard of before we mixed in, before we transgressed from Elohim's laws. He told him, you sin, I'm going to put a sickness on like I put on the Mizraim. That's why we sick. Because we done mixed in with this damn virus.
That's right.
I'm sick of it.
That's right.
Sick of it. Our people are too stupid to even realize these folk killing us.
Yeah.
Come on, son, finish it up.
Covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, not kodash.
That's right, kodash, not holy. Holy refers to some Hindu. Folks be sitting around their head up saying that stuff, talking about being holy. Whole time you didn't realize you're talking about professing to some Hindu. Kodash. Be clean or separated. Why in the world you going to put it on your Bible? The whole time they've been using psychosis to make a fool like running around telling people you holy. The whole time they've been telling you you're Hindu. Another domination from some devils. Listen.
Without natural affection.
Look at that. Without natural affection. Man don't even want a woman no more. He look at a butt-naked woman. He talking about, I'm good. That ain't even natural. That's not natural. Let me show you something. Put me by the sheet. 2 and 18. By the sheet. Other brother, you don't give me a sheet. 2. Give me 17. We'll read down. Other one, see if that's Beth Shumwal. See if it's 11. And 1, we'll read down. Let me see something. Listen.
But of the tree.
2 and 17. Listen.
But of the tree of the knowledge of Taub and evil.
What happened?
Thou shalt not eat of it.
Tell them what happened.
For in the womb that thou eatest thereof.
Tell them what happened.
Thou shalt surely die.
Tell them what happened.
And Elohim said, it is not Taub that the Anus should be alone. I will make him an help meet for him.
Mm-hmm.
And out of the ground, Elohim formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof.
Y'all hear what he said? He said, well, not good that Anus should be alone. He made him a help meet. Then out of the ground formed he every beast of the field. Does that sound correct? Huh? One and about 12. About a sheet 1 and 12. Listen.
And the Arich brought forth grass and herb yielding seed after his kind.
Whose what? Come on.
And the tree yielding fruit whose seed was in itself.
What happened?
After his kind.
Mm-hmm.
And Elohim saw that it was Taub.
Uh-huh.
And the evening and the morning were Yom Shalishi.
Yeah.
And Elohim said, let there be lights in the firmament of Shamayim to divide the Yom from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for Yamim and years, and let them be for Aur in the firmament of the Shamayim to give Aur upon the Aritz.
Yeah.
And it was so.
Listen.
And Elohim made two great Aur, the greater Aur to rule the Yom,
that's
and
right,
the lesser Aur to rule the night.
That's right.
He made the stars also.
For light. He made the stars also.
And Elohim set them in the firmament of Shamayim to give Aur upon the Aritz.
That's right.
And to rule over the Yom and over the night.
What happened?
And to divide the Aur from the Keshak.
Yeah.
And Elohim saw that it was Taub.
What happened?
And the evening and the morning were Yom Rabi'i.
Yes.
And Elohim said, let the Mayim bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life. And the fowl that may fly above the Aritz.
That's right.
And the open firmament of Shamayim.
Yes.
And Elohim created great wells and every living creature that moveth.
See when Elmer got him? He created a great well.
Oh,
There go Amber. Listen.
And every living creature that moveth.
Listen.
Which,
man, you got to demand.
Which the Maim brought forth abundantly.
That's right, Maim, not waters. Come on.
After their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind. And Elohim saw that it was Tau. And Elohim blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the Maim in the seas.
Y'all hear what he told them? Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the Maim. Listen.
And let fowl multiply in the arits.
And let the fowls multiply in the arits. What happened?
And the evening and the morning were Yom Kamishi.
Kamishi, which they're going to call Thursday. Come on. Which is actually the fifth day. Come on.
And Elohim said, let the arits bring forth the living creature after his kind.
Listen.
Cattle and creeping thing and beast of the arits after his kind.
Which we know have been ox. Listen.
And it was so.
Listen.
And Elohim made the beast of the arits after his kind.
Listen.
And cattle after their kind.
And what happened?
And everything that creepeth upon the arits after his kind.
And what happened?
And Elohim saw that it was Tau.
Yeah.
And Elohim said, let us make Anus in our image.
Yeah.
After our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the arits, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the arits.
Okay, that's good. Jump back over right quick at 2:17. Barashit 2:17. Listen.
But of the tree of the knowledge of Taub and evil.
He's talking to the man that he put in the garden. Of the tree of good and evil. What happened?
Thou shalt not eat of it.
What happened?
For in the yom that thou eatest thereof.
Tell him what's going to happen.
Thou shalt surely die.
And what happened?
And Elohim said, it is not Taub that the Anu should be alone.
He just said it was not good. Taub. It is not good that the man should be alone. What you going to do?
I will make him and help meet for him.
I'm going to make somebody that's appropriate for him. Listen what happened.
And out of the ground, Elohim formed every beast of the field.
Now, if you read this the way you just read it, it just told you he made man first, then he created everything else. Because when the man got there, the man seen everything else got a mate. Everything else is repopulated. This is not good. I need to give him somebody. Because he's looking at other things, got something. Everybody getting it on itself for me. I need some Marvin Gaye. And you don't need no Marvin Gaye by yourself. That's why I told you. I don't know how y'all be sitting right here talking about you don't need no woman. I don't know what you got going on. Everybody here getting it on. You need a woman.
That's right.
Huh? You need a woman. Yeah. I'm going what he told him now. Now, this you're going to be a unit now for the sake of the word, for the Dabarim now. Yeah. But you got to dedicate yourself more than what you're doing now. Yeah. When you talking about being a, these y'all going to try to claim going to be a unit for, you're going to be more serious than what you is. You ain't trying to be no unit. I know y'all just lacking responsibility. I know good and well. You ain't trying to be no unit. Cause you, let me tell y'all something. When you look at the 7th chapter of the book of Corinthians, it told you about a woman being Bethula. Bethula going to be a woman ripe for sex, a woman preparing. Well, all Amar was going to be ripe for that. But that's a virgin in her privacy, Bethula. Now, he told a woman, if you do this, he said you can serve Yahuwah better. He said because you can give yourself day and night. That means you're behind 100% day and night. You all about Elohim. I know any way in the hell you about that. Right. I know you not, because it don't show. Right. That's why he told them about a woman being, they're going to put the word virgin. That's not a word, that's their stuff. That's why they got a record called virgin. Have more sex than a little bit. Yep. They crack us in here and blow jaw, have anal sex and still be a virgin. Right. Virgin don't mean nothing. Yeah. Hell, they'll give you a virgin drink and it'll have 0.9%, 90% alcohol in it. And still call it a virgin. You can't believe that. If folk been playing, what they folk call, when you talking about being what they would quote unquote try to call a virgin, you ain't known them, man. That's kissing, hugging, rubbing, fanging, finger looking good, licking good, the whole nine. You know, damn virgin. Y'all cut that fool's down. These white folk give y'all these definitions right here. I ain't really do it that long. I'm a virgin. Yeah, you a virgin. You ain't no virgin. Bethula is a woman separate. When you talk about Maureen, she didn't know a man. Somebody go, that's a damn lie. She didn't know a man. Now, you know she had a father. They didn't talk about that way, knowing him. Kissing, hugging, rubbing, humping, rolling, scrubbing, the whole nine. No. Y'all stop that foolishness. Y'all go in here and get any cracker definition for stuff and run out here and tell that lie, born again virgin. I ain't did in 2 weeks. Hell, you might well have a drink. They get an Israelite come out with that stuff. Now, hell, I'd rather be a Miller Lite than an Israelite. Hell, it's more solid. 999,000. 810 more of them things. I had like a million of them. Tell me, nigga, you might well be a Miller Lite. You sound listening to these folks, man, folks mess you up around him. Y'all hear me? I try to get folks on West Side. Don't let these folks say and play no game with you. The thing you got to do now, being born again. Come on, vent this up, son.
And every fowl of the air, and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to all the cattle, and to the fowl of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found an help meet for him.
Listen.
And Elohim caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam.
What happened?
And he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof.
Listen what happened.
And the rib which Elohim had taken from Anus made he Nishim.
Listen what he said now. Come on.
And brought her unto the Anus.
Listen what he did. He brought her unto who? Listen to the first word he said. This.
And brought her unto the Anus.
And what happened?
And Adam said,
and this listen is what now. He said. This is, hold on, what now?
This is now.
This is what?
This is now.
What it did?
Bone of
that's
my
all
bone.
I want to hear, boy. I'm trying to tell me. He knew what it was. Now, y'all heard him say it. Somebody finna get bone. I done lost a rib. Man, can I? His, I just tell the man say it now. He let him know exactly what this is now. That's a bone. Nowhere in the world. Y'all know where y'all be getting at. Y'all better quit playing with yourself spiritually and literally. I can't say that butt naked woman. That man, shit, what is this? This bone. Ain't letting know what it is. She ain't know what it was. He told her what it is. This is not bone. And you know who bone? This is my bone. This ain't their bone. This is my bone. Huh? And that's my flesh. I'm finna put this rib back in the flesh. All right, now. I don't know what these jokers be thinking about around here. Y'all better stay y'all behind up. Hell, ain't having a wet drink, having a wet fluid. You know, good and done well, you need a woman. Hell, don't woke up all this hell wet, man. You need to get you know, good and done well, you better get you somebody. Cut it out. Come on, let's look at this, Beth, Shumwa. Y'all ain't finna have me like I'm crazy. I'll go down and I'll take the test just to show you. Man, this, Beth, Shumwa. I mean 11 and 1. Let me see what happened. Beth Shumawal. Listen.
And it came to pass, after the year was expired, at the time when Malachim go forth to battle, that Daub sent Joab and his servants with him, and all Yasharal, and they destroyed the children of Ammon, and besieged Rabbah, but Daub tarried still at Jerusalem. And it came to pass in an evening tide that Daub arose from off his bed, and walked upon the roof of the Malachim's house.
Man, walked upon the roof of the Malachim's house. What happened?
And from the roof, he saw a Nashim washing herself.
What? Go ahead and tell me how you can hold out.
And the Nashim was very beautiful to look upon.
God, I'm trying to tell you, but this ain't me. I don't know what y'all be doing around here. That man will walk on the roof. What the world is that? You ain't made for that kind of stuff. Man made to have a wife. I don't know what y'all brought me around here be trying to tell you. I said, any little group had a, I'm good, hand out in your pocket trying to hold up. They ain't good, just stop it. You should not be there for me. Ain't nowhere in the world your done gender error should be able to identify every print in your hand. I'll straighten y'all behind up. Same thing to warm you ain't gonna be able to take no stuff like that. I don't know what these folks be lying themselves for. I don't get it. I date about 4 or 5 years. Man, you'll be on pruned out. You better go and get your behind and straighten up. That's just being honest. I said, in prayer, that man walking up in that room, tell her, what the, oh, stop, look at, man, she's washing that thing. Whoa, tell her, come in. Finna mess up. Now, you know she ain't come up that neck. That man sat there and seen that. We like, man, I got to see some more of that. I said, well, how are they like? I'm good, I'm good, I'm chilling, I'm chilling, chilling. Hell, you breaking a cold sweat. How you chilling? Oh, wait, I sweat when it get hot. Now, I be telling y'all the truth. I don't be sitting around here lying to you. So y'all be having any conversation. I don't be having, man, I ain't had no conversation y'all be having. Y'all see, y'all just hanging. Man, I don't be hearing them dumb conversation. Just dumb. Just stop it. He ain't making that better for no man than a woman.
Right.
He ain't making that better for no woman than a man.
Right.
Yeah, I'm trying to get myself together. You got something in your pan and you got bones. You need to get yourself together. You should have been together.
Yeah.
I mean, if I'm trying to wait, get by eight, like 12 more months. Man, please. Come on, that joke. That joke take that long. You're trying to get something. You're going to be in trouble later. Man, hurry up. He do something quickly.
Yeah.
Ain't that right? That thou do quickly.
Yeah.
Ain't that right? Being honest, man, put yourself in position. You'll be no transgressor.
Yeah.
Like y'all crazy or something in here. Be hearing that stuff, man, that stuff sound gay. Yeah. You better come out and tell me you're a eunuch. You better prove it quick. I don't want you around here. You better be able to quote every Bible verse come up. That's what he said. He said that damn man. He said, you can get yourself to fasting and praying.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, man, it'd be you all be fasting. Oh, I don't want to see your ass eating, drinking nothing.
Right.
Hey, he wept. Just keep going. Well, that's it. Come forth. Just keep quoting. Just going the whole time. I didn't hear so love the word again. Only got beings. Whosoever lives, that's all I want to hear. You ain't doing anything but get your ass and get married. Crazy. I don't never seen something come. I'd be sit back and watch something. I'd be saying to myself, but God knew what they be thinking about. That is crazy.
Yeah.
He made no man look at that. He said everything here screwing. Well, they ailment now. Another way, whales ain't touched again. They look and say, well, that one ailment ain't having sick, but the rest of everything else in. Isn't that right? But other than that, everybody, he look at all them ailments like that. Man, everybody getting something. I'm just saying, no. How do you say everybody got somebody? No, you got to get yourself tightened up. Y'all tell y'all, so he ain't never intended man to be by himself. He said it ain't good. It's not ta'ud that he should be alone. He gonna mess up. They don't like that. They gotta stop preaching. That do it. Come on back over here. Let's get this second temple so I can move and clean this on up for him. So I don't want to have to touch on all these different areas avenues, try to get folks straightened out. For all like, how much money it take to get married? Be honest with y'all, I tell y'all to get the basis amount. At least just show yourself faith or word to get there. If you're a go-getter, you'll make it happen. I did it. I did. I had my mind. I knew what I had to do, man. Let me start sitting right up with Mr. Palm and his $5. Man, I had to do something else. They're being honest now. You're going to mess up now. Go and get y'all behind together. Keep sitting right here. Keep scooming all over your doing self. Stop it. Go and get your wife. Got me one of them, I had to goddamn grind. You ain't gonna never get enough money. You get that, you're gonna need some more. Yep. Keep making excuse. You ain't gonna do nothing. You're a go-getter, you got that, you make it out. You got these folks in that head to do that. Once you got it, you'll be surprised.
Yep.
You make it work. And you got your mindset, yeah, you make it work. Well, I'm trying to get like a 15-bedroom house. I know. Hell, all them, your forefathers made in a shanty in the wood.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Keep trying to make all them excuse. You got a mind to do the right thing, you got that to do it. It's gonna work for you. Book said, all things work together for them that love Yahuwah and call according to his purpose.
Right.
Do you love him? Or you call according to his purpose?
Right.
Well, it got to work out for me.
Yeah.
It got to work for me. I love him.
Yeah.
If you don't love him, I wouldn't do it.
Yeah.
Y'all all right?
Right.
Come on, finish the third chapter.
Put them in mind to be subject to principalities and powers to obey magistrates.
Verse 7? Verse 8, where you at? 3 and 5. Where you at?
Titus.
Titus.
He was reading Titus.
Where is he in Titus? You got your own little gospel in? It got to be gospel because I ain't gave it to him. It's a spell on you, son? All right, tighten it up. Let's go, son.
This know also that in the last Yamim, perilous times shall come.
But what happened?
A noose shall be lovers of their own selves.
What happened?
Covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, not kudash, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are ta'ub, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of Elohim, having a form of Elohim.
See, that, you know what? Christianity has a form. Hindu has a form. Islam has a form. Buddhism has a form. No, all of them have a being. Everybody has a being. They have something or some force, Scientology. That's what get people. I like Sensei because, you know, so it allows you and you can do your own thing. That's your problem. The whole problem with what you try to look at and people look at religion, you need some structure. You know that for the fact you live in a house that's got a structure. And it's guidelines involved in order to build that structure. So structure is not a bad thing. You got me? You just got to know how to structure it correctly. And the way we learn to structure it correctly is by going back to do like he said. Staying in the ways and see. When you do, let's ask for the old path. How long has Buddhism been here? Islam, Christianity, Scientology, Catholicism. That's why he told me, look at all of them. But then what I need to do, when I get finished, you know what you have to come back and look at? Abari. You got to look at Abari. When you look at Abari, you're going to find out that's been him. Before all these other religions were formed and put, you're going to be able to go back and look at Abari. That's why he was able to tell Abraham when the book about a sheep, he told him, walk before me and be what? Which means he already had a culture. He had already given him statues and ritual. Same way you're going to look at when you go back to look at the reason we have Barashit. It means in the beginning. Tell me what could be him before the beginning. So in the beginning, we find out what he did. He bara, which is he created. Isn't that right? The Shamayim and the Arit. At, he put the signs there. Y'all got me? He put the signs in the Arit. We the sign here. He told you that ye are the light. Well, he already told you what the light was for. It was for sign. It was for season. And guess what it was for? For years. You need to know that. Because people didn't pay attention when Yahushua came. 40 years. No generation. Which was still the same thing he told you. The Aur. He told you that I was the Aur of the Arits. So when he came here, he was for sign. They asked him, they told him that they seek a what? Where you going to seek a sign from? I just told you where you going to get it from. For the order, which is the life. These ignorant people don't know nothing. Now, how in the hell you going to find a way when you don't even know what order is? Yeah. You don't even know why he came from Shamayim and he came here because he was showing you I was his sign in the wrist and I was a sign. I mean, his sign in the Shamayim and I was a sign when I was on the wrist, which means you need to, that's why they came. They said, we seek. People are so stupid. Look at the book of Matthew 4. It's so much stuff people don't know. How you going to find salvation when you hadn't even been drawn? Then how you don't even know what to look for. Matthew chapter 4, verse 9. We'll read down. Let's see what he said. Listen.
And saith unto him, all these things will I give thee, if thou wilt fall down and worship me.
That's what he worked for, done did for you now. When you see these athletes, all these people, actors and singers, perform with all their money and stuff they got, because they done took and they done heeded what he told them. They done fell and bowed down to him so they can get some. Okay. Y'all ain't got to believe it. That's what these people have done. Listen.
Then saith Yahushua unto him.
What did he say?
Get thee hence, Satan. For it is written, thou shalt worship Yahuwah thy Elohim, and him only shalt thou serve.
Yeah.
Then the devil leaveth him, and behold, Malachi came and ministered unto him. Now when Yahushua had heard that Jehochanan was cast into prison, he departed into Galilee.
Pay attention, what did he do?
He departed into Galilee.
He departed where?
Into Galilee.
He departed where?
Into Galilee.
I only asked him to keep saying it for a reason. Let's see what he told him.
And leaving Nazareth.
And leaving Nazareth.
He came and dwelt in Capernaum.
Tell them what happened.
Which is upon the seacoast in the borders of Zebulun and Naphtali.
Tell them why.
That it might be fulfilled which
that
was spoken.
That it might be fulfilled. That means come into completion. that it might come into completion. Tell them what it happened.
Which was spoken by Yashiyahu the Nabah, saying, the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtalim.
Where about?
By the way of the sea.
What, which was where?
Beyond Jordan.
Listen.
Galilee of the Gentiles.
You ain't going to believe what happened. Tell them what happened, Brandon.
The people which sat in Kashak.
The people that sat in Kashak, which is obscurity. They'll call it darkness. Tell them what did they do, Brandon?
Saw a great aor.
Pay attention to what they did. They saw a great aor. And tell them what happened.
And to them which sat in the region and shadow of death.
Tell them what happened, son.
Aor is sprung up.
And where do you think it sprung up from? From the Aritz, which was a sign. That's why they came and told him, we seek a sign. Well, if you seek a sign, guess where you're going to come to? You're going to come to aor. This is why he tried to tell you. This is why you know these people don't know what they're doing. No man can come unto me except the Abba which sent him, drawing. See me, he got to draw him. I know how I got here. He got to draw you to this. And I'll raise him up in the last day. It's written in the bar. They all got to be taught of Elohim. Every man, therefore, that had heard and learned of the Abba, you had to come to the sign. I'm sorry, come to the order. That's where your sign going to come from. When he left a sign him. Same thing he did when he left before in Barashit. When the sign left, you ain't going to believe this, he still left a sign. That's what he put the other light there. When I'm gone, I left something to still be here and witness. Because the people still needed a sign. That's bad. At the second chapter of the book of Acts of the Apostles. Acts chapter 2. Acts 2 and 14. Listen.
But Cuff,
standing
up with the 11,
lifted up
his voice and said unto them,
ye men
of Yehuda,
and all ye
that dwell at Jerusalem,
be this known
unto you,
and hearken
to my dabarim.
For these are not drunken,
as ye suppose,
seeing
it is but the third hour of the yom.
But this is that
which was spoken by the Nabah Yahual.
Yahual, with saying what?
It shall come to pass in the last yamim,
that,
saith Elohim,
that what happened?
I will pour out of my ruach upon all flesh.
And what happened?
Your ben and your daughters shall divine ruach, and your young anus shall see kazun,
and
your old anus shall dream dream.
And what happened?
And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those yamim of my ruach, and they shall divine ruach.
And listen what's going to happen.
I will shew wonders in Shamayim above.
Which means I will show Ot. It's going to make sense. He told you where it's going to start at. I'm going to show signs where?
In Shamayim above.
Which is going to be Ot, his sign, in the Shamayim. That's why we know him as his son. It was his son, meaning his sign. And what else?
Signs in the Aritz beneath.
Ot. A sign in their writs beneath. This is what I'm going to show you.
Blood.
What else?
Fire.
That's going to be light. And?
Vapor of smoke.
That's what I'm talking about. When is it going to happen?
The sun shall be turned into Kashak.
So he just told you that the sun was going to be black. Why was you looking for a white man? I just told you what color the sun was going to be. How they showed you a cracker all these years? I just told you what color the sun was going to be. Now the whole priest, why I darkened it, really showing you that the sun was going to be black. Why was you looking for a cracker? Listen.
And the moon into blood before that great and notable yom of Yahuwah come.
That great and notable day of Yahuwah come. See, all these things we're supposed to look for, these signs, this is what let us know. That's why he told you you were going to be for signs and for seasons. That's what they know. I'll change it. Just like we're coming back over now and we're transforming by information. These people ain't stupid. You know why I open this camera and let them know? The people that are watching me out there know things are turning. They ain't no fool. They know this. That's saying, Thomas, I'm going to grow a beard now. I know see Sam said it said. Now, he used to didn't say that. He used to be different at. You know what they're for? Letting them know. Season changing. And it's a sign in their wrist to let them know. Okay. I don't know what these folks doing. I'm trying to tell y'all, things are changing. It's a changing of the tide for these people. Y'all hear me? And all I'm doing is what the book told y'all we're going to do. At the book of Daniel, chapter 11, they're going to call him Dan. His name is Daniel, meaning he's judge of Elohim, judge of all Elohim. 11, see if it's about 35. I'm going to get ready and let y'all go in a minute. We got to be in here for a while because we got to educate our people. We can't keep being dumbfounded. Our kids count. I look at my boys, I tell them, I always want to be an example. I always want to be somebody my boys can look back to and know that daddy was a man. Y'all hear me? Dad a man, son. Ain't no girl him. Dad a man. Establishing man. I'm making men. I do just like Elohim did. He built a man. When he looked, he couldn't find one. He built them. Huh? He told Yahu then to say, he said, go through. Look at the gate in the broad place. He said, if it be in it, if you can find one. He couldn't find one. He had to build him. He built the man. That's why he put him back in the garden and raised him up. He had to build him. He couldn't find one. Huh? Yekazi all told you he looked for him. He said, I look for a man to stand the gap to make up the head for the land that I should not destroy. Couldn't find one. If I can't find one, that's why I told you the difference with us versus how they took away our resilience. Now, he could have let this whole thing been destroyed since he couldn't find a man. He had enough sense to realize, well, why don't I make one? Hell, if I can't find a job, why don't I just create me one? You see the different mindset of him versus the way these crackers done gave you? The cracker says that naturally go apply for welfare and wait on these crackers to give you something. I'm of Elohim. I'll make it. When your cold got back home, what they gave him? He had to make it. He had to make it. He didn't go back home. He went back there because that's the place of my father. There I can get where I can make it. You ain't going to never make it in these cracker system. Why are you still trying to be subservient to following these people and bowing down homage DP? These people ain't going to never let you be nothing here. You're under their government, under their rule. Their government, their rule, their education system is set up for them. It ain't set up for you. Why you think your kids are failing? Hell, you ain't got enough sense to know, do you? Huh? Inherently, you're not going to be able to pick up their stuff the way they pick it up. There's too many game changers behind hidden languages. Hell, you can't give me no definition, no word. First of all, you need to know the adjective, you need to know the verb, and you need to know the noun. Hell, most of them don't know but one definition. They're too damn stupid. They see now, they run the first one. Man said, well, what's the adjective? Adjective what? The adjective. What's the verb? Hell, that's how you can't trap him up. Every time you think you smart, most of you look up a word, tell the truth. You want to pick up the first definition to start. Am I correct? He got you right there because you ain't getting nothing but the noun. Go look at the adjective. That's how I got away. And then you think, smart, how you going to beat this cracker? He changed the game every time. Hell, he gave you checkers. You can only go this way, this way. Hell, he made chess. I can go this. No, but I got the rook. Oh, the bishop. Hell, you can't win. He going to change the rule every time. He'll write a book and let you and still beat you. Why you talking about write a book and give you the damn answer? He make a game and make cheat codes for it. What the hell purpose me making a game and make cheat codes for it? The game probably made, probably fairly played. The person, the book said a man can't be strived for master unless he strived lawfully. Hell, he been a cheater ever since she met him. He ain't got a video game, he ain't got a cheat code for it. You say, hey, you been working your ass out to try to get up to level 15, ain't got past level 3. Hell, he on level 100. Yeah. I'm like, man, I can't get nowhere. He said, well, you need the cheat code. I'm like, the cheat code? Hell, that's how he do everything. You ain't going to outrun him. Hell, he going to use a laser. Laser lie like he lie. Yeah. He ain't going to be that way. He got rid of Star Wars. They think it's more accurate. Hell, it ain't no more accurate. When I start the clock, hell, the clock ain't cheap. Hell, I go, boom. Stop. Yep. You need to let that laser lie for that cracker.
That's right.
Y'all always be thinking these crackers accurate. They don't believe they build up. They build stuff so they lie more technology. They got more technology how you can't catch him. Yep. Well, y'all need to think. That's how they think these folks get them so they think it's more accurate. See, it's accurate. According to who? The man who done wrote every lie you know, done taught you every lie, hell, he done made an accurate laser.
Right.
I'm so stupid. Time ain't lying on Time still remain the same. That's why we look at you, who he told. He said, your years ain't going to fail. Because they ain't going to mess with his time. They're going to change your time. They giving you these days and months. That's why they got you sit around thinking you're in the first of a year. Making a fool out of you again. And then y'all told they're going to do. He's going to think to change it. Because we ain't following him. He can put January right there all he wants to. Hell, we know this the 10th month. This is the 10th moon. But all these stupid people don't let him change. They got them follow January and you follow another Greek goddess. What you going to do with him? He ain't fooling everybody. He turned our people back. This is what he's doing. He's turning back to his people like he told you. He has not cast away his people. He said he foreknew. Yahuwah has turned back to us. And these crackers watch me now open up so they can see. He done turned me back. Let's see what Daniel said going to happen. Daniel chapter 11 and verse 35. All that cracking on tongue was a passive doctrine. Again, cracker is not the derogatory. Cracker means the person that in charge of the whip. You wouldn't know that either. Listen.
And some of them of understanding shall fall.
Y'all hear that?
Them.
And some of them of understanding. Hold on. Back me up and make it by verse 33. 11:33. Let's see what happened. Listen.
And they that comprehend among the people shall instruct many.
Oh, back me up a little more. Make it 11:30. Listen.
For the ships of Shittim shall come against
them. See that? What kind of ship going to take you somewhere and drop you off and mess you up? Got to be some shit, Tim. What other kind of ship it going to be? What kind of ship will leave you in some shit like this? A shit ship, Tim. Listen.
Therefore he shall be grieved and return and have indignation against the Kadosh covenant.
See that? He got to see that? The man grieved with the Kadosh covenant. This is what happened.
So shall he do. He shall even return and have intelligence with them that forsake the Kadosh covenant.
Let me tell you something else. Look at Donald Trump, who he mean with, Steve Harvey. Hell no, he done forsook it. One of the worst damn impressions I ever seen of Richard Pryor in my life. Hell, I'd rather watch Eddie Murphy do it. Just a disgraced fathead bastard. Them people we ain't got Kanye damn West and he's standing over near the North. Don't know where he at. These are the people he's sitting out having intelligence with, people that forsake the Kodosh covenant. Look at the people who Donald Trump, all these folk gonna mess with. All the people he get, he want to get with Putin, he want to get with all these people, people that forsake the covenant. Watch these people. Listen.
An arm shall stand on his part.
Oh, the military. Look at all the people who Donald Trump put in his cabinet. Generals, ex-generals. General that was forced in retirement. General that spent 40 years. All they know is war and battle. Hell, they ain't never been in no field, did no work. What kind of what give me an award for putting people out here risking their life, got people killing themselves? Why would I be getting an award? Call some great general. Get your ass out there with a gun and you fight. Daoud was a warrior. When Abraham went to go to, he ain't sitting nobody knowing he went with him. Them jokes ain't gonna get in no field. They got in that field and they went again, shot at and again, bombed and grenade. They'll realize they wouldn't be so quick to put people's lives out there. Hell, you sitting back somewhere. Them jokes ain't nowhere near nowhere getting bombed. Only way the hell they gonna get bombed is in a bar. Listen.
And they shall pollute the sanctuary of strength.
And that's what they're doing. Listen.
And shall take away the daily sacrifice. And they shall place the abomination that maketh desolate.
That's why they give you that white Jesus, folded up legs of him. They give you the abomination that make desolation. That's why he took us out, because we did the very thing he told us. We done bowed down the image of the God, gave them false, crickety, white hands, prayed up together, talking about no praying, them cracker hands, crooks and robbers. And you sitting down, damn, bowing down, praying to it. What you think? Go look at all these churches. I don't got the same stuff with a table with them damn hands on a cross up there. And you study, fall down to an idol. They took it out and gave us the abomination with making desolation. That's why we got, that's why we've been dispersed. Because you done sat here, you done ate of these people's sacrifice. They done fed you everything he told you not to get. You done lodged in monuments and mountains. I told him before, he was out to stay off the top of that damn stone mountain. Did I just say that? I've been told y'all about it. You missed me on that. Oh, you got me, yeah. But I've been told y'all about that. Those are idol gods on the front of that damn mountain. And y'all said he done told you about y'all sitting them on top of them damn mountains. That's what them folks, they worship on them mountains. Why you think they go up there for Easter? Yeah, right. Hell, they go up there because that's their gun. They go up there and they pray. That ain't right. That's a monument. That's what he sent them to destroy. Tear down their monument. Destroy their gods. Right. Always running here right at that damn fucking mind. Them folks got up there and told them damn weirdos.
Yep. Yep.
Always run up on that shit, Tim.
That's right. That's right.
These crackers got another agenda. Your mind thinking you doing some natural habitat. Hell, that's that mind of going toward them other gods.
Yeah.
Y'all don't even know what y'all be doing here. And I tell y'all that this, don't you know you got the mind of a transgressor?
Yeah.
Hell, I tell you, so I see further than you see.
Yeah.
I be damn running up here thinking y'all see some dope people worship at those places.
Yeah,
Ukanah. 4:22. I'm finna this up. I put a lot up here. I just be trying to help y'all a lot. Everybody be thinking, he try to control us. He don't want, hell, I'm trying to save your life, you ass. Trying to keep your head you in before you get your behind killed out here. Hell, ain't been wearing drawers but 2 weeks. I had on drawers there about all my life. Come out, cross diapers, right in the drawers. Go to the store by myself since I was 3. Hell, how you gonna have more sense than me? Hell, I go in there and see Mr. Vick getting the note, Mr. Vick getting the money, give him a change, give him a... Go right on home. Don't even go with strangers. Go to school bus since I was 5 years. Hell, you were 20. You still can't go to the store by your damn self. Get lost and pulled out. Man, I had too much sense, too long. They don't realize, grunt, man, you had to catch up. Let me tell you what shoot a lot of y'all. Y'all airheads. Like, it's not all of you, no, airheads. Y'all don't catch on to stuff. We were talking about stuff of importance, and I use ass, damn, and hell. Because I get so angry, I'm trying to spike you to think. You're not smart as you think. Stuff you do is dumb because you're not paying attention. He done told you by larger than any damn amount, this is what those people do. He pulled us away from that foozing. Ukanah 4:22. Listen.
Ye worship.
You know what?
Not what.
What do we know?
We know what we worship. For salvation is of the Yahudim.
And what's going to happen?
But the hour cometh.
No, I'm going to get it. But the hour what?
Cometh.
When what?
And now is when the true worshipers.
Shall do what?
Worship the Abba.
And what?
Ruach and Amat.
And then take them up to verse 19. Listen.
The woman saith unto him.
What did she say?
Sir, I perceive that thou art a Nabah.
She perceived that he was a Nabah. And what happened?
Our Abba worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where Anus ought to worship.
Listen.
Yahusha saith unto her.
What did he say?
Nashim, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Abba.
Change of behavior. So I keep running up these places thinking y'all got something, y'all found stuff. You hadn't found nothing. The best thing you can find is OB. You know what he told him was better than sacrifice? And the hearken. Yahuwah cannot bless you in nothing y'all doing. This is several of y'all. I used him starting off, but this hit all y'all. When I tell y'all do something, you don't do it. There's no way nothing's going to work for you. You can fight what I tell you all you want to. You're going straight to hell. Because that book done told you to obey them. They had a rule over you and submit. He watching for your soul. I watch for y'all soul, Ben. Y'all watch. I tell y'all do stuff, y'all keep doing. I guarantee I'm watching for your soul. You ain't watching for your soul. You too damn stupid. You can't watch for your soul. You too stupid. If I'm telling you to do not to do something you're doing, do you not know you too dangerous? I'm clearly telling you something because I'm watching for your soul. I got to give an account. You not worried about you going to meet this man. He going to send you to hell for your disobedience. That's how important it is to do what you're told when you're talking about who ruled over you. When Shaul came, in the 22nd chapter, right quick, said 22:1, or Acts of the Apostles. And we're going to finish that thing, y'all. I'm going to get rid of that. I just be wanting y'all to pay attention. See that 22:1. Listen.
Anus.
Listen.
Anus, Aki, and Abbas. Hear ye my defense.
He said, men, brethren, hear ye my defense. What happened?
Which I make now unto you.
Yeah.
And when they heard that he spake in the Abari tongue to them,
yeah,
they kept the more silence. And he saith, I am verily an Anus, which am a Yehudi.
No, bad memory. See if it's 20 is what I want. Number 23. Listen.
And after the uproar was ceased, Shaul called unto him the taught ones and embraced them.
No, 23. 23 and 1. Thank you. 23 and 1. Listen.
And Shaul, earnestly beholding the council,
had a said, most serious state of mind when he was looking at the council. What happened?
Said, Anus and Aki.
What happened?
I have lived in all Taub conscience before Elohim until this yom.
Y'all hear what he said? Up until this very day, right, I done did, and I've had a good conscience toward Elohim. Up until this day. Up until now. What happened?
And the high Kohan and Ananias commanded them that
the
stood by.
The high Kohan commanded him that stood by to do what?
To smite him on the mouth.
What happened?
Then said Shaul unto him.
What did he say? Turn the other cheek.
Elohim shall smite thee, thou whited wall.
Let me ask y'all a question. I'm just curious. Shaul. Do y'all believe that Shaul was a man of Elohim, a true man? How many of y'all believe that with all your heart? How y'all believe? He said concerning the law, he was blaming. How many of y'all believe that? I believe that. That book. Why did he do railing for railing when you were told about not you're supposed to entreat evil? You weren't supposed to resist evil. That's what they teach you in their law. Why didn't he just keep his mouth closed and he got slapped on the mouth and said, slap me again, I'm supposed to invite evil in? Why was his instinct natural when he was slapped in the mouth to go off and say something back? These crackers teach you, you ain't supposed to say nothing back, not answering again. He wasn't supposed to answer back when he was slapped on his mouth. He said, I said unto you that you supposed, he told you not to resist evil. Meaning, if I slap in your mouth, keep your mouth poked, let me keep slapping it. He got slapped on the mouth. He said, what now? What happened, brother? Because I'm confused. What happened now?
Then said Shaul unto him,
what happened?
Elohim shall smite thee.
Now, what happened to Shaul before that? Because I'm confused.
And the high Kohan, Ananias, commanded them that stood by him to smite him on the mouth.
And why? And then he should be saying, I'm just suffering like my Jesus did. And what happened?
Then said Shaul unto him.
What did he say?
Elohim shall smite thee, thou whited wall.
See that? Jeff went off on him. Told him, you're going to get slapped in your damn mouth. Why in the world he say that? Why did he just keep his mouth closed, stay humble like a lamb? But what happened?
For sittest thou to judge me after the law?
That man done went off. And what happened?
And commandest me to be smitten contrary to the law?
He just called him a hypocrite. So his mouth ain't stopped yet. And the man just said he done lived in good conscience the whole time, even today. You ain't supposed to tell no people that, is you? Call him a hypocrite? Told him you're going to get slapped in your damn mouth? I'm confused. I'm just confused. What would Jesus do? Hell, I wouldn't care what Jesus do. I'm looking at what Yahushua would do, which is the name of his son. This is Latin for earth pig, slave ship. Which means this man was, he sent this man, hold on for a second, 9 and 14, Exodus Apostles. I'm confused. Maybe I need to find out who he is. I'm confused. Let me just see something. I'm confused. I'm confused. I know I put a lot up here today, but I tell y'all what. That's a lot y'all need to know, though. Ooh, we ain't get to hit everything. Just help y'all out for a second. This is 9 and 14. Listen.
And here he hath authority from the Rosh Kohan.
This is Ananias. And he telling Yahushua concerning Shaul when he done told him to go and see this man. He said, this man got authority of the chief Kohan to do what?
To bind all that call on thy name.
To call on your name. To call on the name of Yahushua. What happened?
But Yahuwah said unto him.
Rather, Yahuwah said unto him.
Go thy way.
Go thy way. You say Yahuwah said unto him, or that would be Yahushua.
But Yahushua said unto him.
What did he told him to do?
Go thy way.
For he
is a chosen vessel unto me.
To do what?
Bear my name before the Gentiles.
Before the Gentiles, that's other nation.
And Malachim.
And for rulers.
And the children of Yasharal.
And the children of Yasharal. For what reason?
I will shew him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake.
Now he suffered for his name's sake. Why he didn't keep his mouth shut? Now, you know, that ain't make no sense. You slap me in my mouth, I tell you, you can get slapped in your damn mouth. Let you know up front you're a hypocrite. I'm confused. He just said the man was a witness. The man talking to rulers. 23-1. People don't want to, you know what? They taught you the passive Christianity doctrine, and they can't prove it out. Now he just said the man was sent to bear his name. The man been slapped in the mouth. He strike right back. He doesn't know. All he gonna slap you in your damn mouth. You hypocrite. In front of the camera, you a hypocrite. These people bringing up prosecuting us in their courtroom contrary to what their own law say, and we supposed to sit there humble like a lamb. To be like Jesus. To be like him. Slave nigga song. Listen.
And Shaul, earnestly beholding the council, said, Anus and Aki, I have lived in all Taub conscience before Allahim until this yom.
See that? All the way up into now I've been doing right. What happened?
And the high Kohan Ananias commanded them that stood by him to smite him on the mouth.
And what happened?
Then said Shaul unto him,
what did he say?
Allahim shall smite thee, thou whited wall. Come for on. Sittest thou to judge me after the law, and commandest me to be smitten contrary to the law.
And what happened?
And they that stood by said, revilest thou Allahim's high Kohan.
And what happened?
Then said Shaul, I wist not, Aki, that he was the high Kohan.
For what happened?
For it is written, thou shalt not speak evil of the ruler of thy people.
That tight. That tight. 23-1, Matayahu. Matayahu. See, when I told them people they going to hell, from Keita, Gina, Tim, Mike, everyone burning hell. I pray they don't get no repentance. Andre, to you involved, I pray y'all burn in hell forever. At least you with them. I pray y'all don't get out. That's my earnest prayer. They can believe what they want. Not one of them going to make it in. Because you know what's going to get them? Unlike Shaul, he said, I didn't know he was a Rosh Kohan. I was saying, and the book told you, he was earnest. They missed that. He was honest when he was looking. But he realized he had got that with a high Kohan said, do it. Why he didn't say, I don't care who it is. I don't give a damn. He said, that's not law. That's not law. See the difference with law? Law don't change because how you feel now. Law's still law. Let's see what happened at the 23rd chapter of the book of Matayahu 23-1. So I shoot them down every time. So they got me ran their mouth. They didn't know who I was, though. They knew. And I said, retain your sins. They can go get remarried. They can go wherever they want to. I assure you, they're going to burn in hell. Elmer 2, that is my earnest prayer. There'll be no repentance for you, that you burn forever. Hell can't get him quick enough for you. That's my earnest prayer for them. Earnest prayer. They ain't going to be moved. They ain't going to be changed. Ain't nothing they can do in life. Ain't no sacrifice. Ain't no repentance for them. I assure you that. They going to hell. Do y'all think he was right for having Shaul slapped in the mouth? How many of y'all think he was right for doing that? I don't believe he should have done it. He shouldn't have. He told him he was right. He shouldn't have slapped him in the mouth. That's right. He told him. Shaul wasn't wrong with what he said. He just didn't realize that with a high Kohan.
Right.
He just told him. Otherwise, if y'all say it right, then Shaul's a liar.
Right. Right.
Okay, y'all got to pay attention. You just got to pay attention now. He commanded me, he just told him that. This is actually contrary to the law.
Right.
This would make you a hypocrite because you're sitting here judging me and you just had me struck in the mouth and this is contrary to the law. But that became a problem. 23-1. Let's see what happened.
Then spake Yahusha.
Who are they talking?
Then spake Yahusha.
Then spake who?
Yahusha.
And what happened?
To the multitude.
He said he told it to the multitude. What did he tell the multitude?
And to his taught ones.
What did he tell his taught ones?
The scribes.
And the who?
Pharisees.
What did they do?
Sit in Musha's seat.
All.
Therefore, whatsoever they bid you observe, that observe and do.
That's tight. That's tight. That would have changed his opinion. I didn't know who he was when I made that statement. Because he came back and told you what the book said. He said, the scripture said, the law, you shouldn't revile the ruler of your people. Y'all will do it. You going to hell, though. The difference with him now, I didn't know who it was. Even it came down to him going against the name, he told you, I thought truly that I should do things contrary to the name. I didn't know that that was the name, and I was killing people that were called the name. That's a difference. See, a lot of them folks in here want to try to use that. That's not going to fit you. That's why these people got to go to hell. See, there's a difference. He had letters, and you heard whether or not this man had letters and authority from the high Kohan, which going to get him right here. They said it, Moshe seed. All they bid you to do, do it. So that's why he can tell y'all, if you actually look, you'll find out I'm blameless. And when they killed Stephen, called on Elohim, you ain't going to believe what the men did. They laid their coat at his feet, the witnesses' feet. They laid them right there. He had to witness it. He had to make sure everything was done according to the law. The witness at hand had to be first upon it. I'm only here to make sure it's carried out. Because concerning the law, blameless. They be trying to go and use stuff and pick up busy people. These people don't know what they're doing. Too stupid to know what you're doing. They told him to do it, but why he went and did it? What did he told you to do? They said in Moshasi. Whatever they bid you to do, do it. But don't do it after they mount him. He's going to give an account for having him slapped in his mouth. But that ain't your job. That's what they mess up at. That ain't your job. They mess up so many times, they tell you. Don't you remember I used to straighten past out all the time over there? You remember I used to get up and straighten him out? You remember one time he got on me, one time I preached about that vacuum cleaner? Did I withstand him? I just told him, I said, if you want to tell them people that they can do it, you do it. I said, I'm not going to tell them. Did I not? I got them and him had it out right in front of people, didn't it? That's a bit different between me and a lot of y'all and him. These people know me, they'll tell you that. I ain't do no foolishness like that. And we wasn't no child no better than that. That wasn't going to be profitable. No more been profitable to fight my dad in public. You know what? You can be right in your own eyes. But it ain't going to be right in people. You know they're going to tell you. I remember my mommy to come in my room and sit down, a little kid. I watch my mom, I wake up, she was sitting there crying. I said, I'm going to kill him. She said, don't ever say that. That's your dad. My mama never told me, yeah, one day, son, you'll kill. She said, that's your daddy. She tell me, she said, that's your daddy. She said, don't never say that. That's dead. Because I was like, he wrong, though. He wrong. She said, that's your daddy. It make a difference. That's what he tried to let you know. I don't know how you're going to get past that. So a lot of stuff y'all be doing, shoot you in the foot. In your mind, just what we was trying to show you in the 14th chapter of Marshall Lee, there is a way that seemed right. But the end of that be death to you. Because y'all don't consider what I told you. You're not being obedient. A lot of times y'all have your own mind about stuff. You don't know what you think you know. Y'all get excited because you got something to think. They're going to rail you off somewhere. It's going to rail you the wrong way. Take your time and follow. There's a lot that goes on with what I'm doing. There's a lot of response. To whom much is given, much is required. A lot of times y'all do stuff, you don't sit down to think. You're going to pay. A lot of y'all say, Pastor Ron, he was, they ain't going to be your job. They're going to be his job. He don't come back, ain't nothing I done, I'm going to get away with. That's what people, that man ain't get away with that because he smited him on the mouth. He just let him know. The law ain't going to change for you. Well, you Shaul, I'm saying you get him straight. He even told you, I didn't know who that was. Y'all done seen that movie Bait before? Who said movie Jamie Foxx? When he was at that Jazz Joker, snapped him. He said, come on in here one time. He said, come on in here one time up under the bed. I'll give you some. Come on here. And everybody brought him that offer. He had him there, set him down. He said, I want to apologize by earlier. I was out of line. He said, I had been doing curls and stuff. You know what I'm saying? I was out of line. No, he really, I was out of line. I didn't know this was the Rosh Kohan had commanded me to be slapped on the mouth. That's a big difference. Big difference. So a lot of stuff I try to get y'all to take your time and do, you don't know what you think you know. You're running, going all these damn places, jumping up all these places, going, you don't know what you think you know. You be running, doing stuff, and the whole time you're sitting around, you'll be doing the stuff of these devils out here. He told my people to be larger and greater. These bastards be burying people in these places. Y'all don't realize some of these places are monuments. These folks got dead people in the bottom of these places. They do these places like pyramids. Your ass just right up here. He done told you about my people lodging among graves. eating swine flesh in the mouth. Why you think these apes be cutting up these rats, giving them your ass? They know what they're doing. Your book told you about that in the mouth. That's why these crackers let them bring that stuff in here. Passing it for lamb meat. Who are the people they going to, who buying this lamb meat? Go to, do this. When you go to Fogo de Chão, look at how many of them folks are eating lamb meat. Them bastards eating ribs. Them bastards want pork and they want bloody meat coming to them. Them bastards don't hardly want no lamb.
Right.
They be like, lamb, that tastes gamey. Bring me some more ribs out here. So they know the people they need to try to induce and try to induce with this stuff and introduce it to us. They need to defy us. That's what he said. He said, my people are full of swine flesh and the mouse. You larger in graves than these monuments. Your ass all on these mountains running up this stuff. And these folks got their junk set all on the bottom, on the top of it. They're like, who knew the Lincoln Memorial is something they done got to goddesses?
Right.
Hell, to know that every one of these black leaders always running your ass up there. Because
yep.
He's showing you right there. These people don't even know. He don't talk about people don't even consider. Hell, you sit on top of that, running all of that slow ass. Why don't run up on top of some damn God? Why y'all think these crackers cut all this stuff and put on these mountains? We don't know nothing about these people. We're assuming it's a monument. Who would have thought that Abraham Lincoln sitting down is a damn Greek goddess? This stuff come from Greece. What do you think they get this stuff from Stone Mountain from?
Our people. My people.
That's why I get so angry. Y'all just be going. I'm free. I can breathe. I have no drawers on. I can go up the mountains and run. Last day y'all be running to, these people have a whole nother agenda. In the woods, twin ass out here in the rain. No damn gas. Watch some leaves fall. Y'all asses be doing stuff, running out here. Y'all don't know where y'all be at. These crackers in these state parks, they have a whole, y'all don't even look these parks up to see where these people get this stuff from. From the names to their agenda, your ass just got to go running. It ain't doing nothing. Hell, you're still slow, mentally and physically. Always trying to run everywhere these crackers get. Y'all better start thinking. Y'all just don't pay attention. None of these people do. And it's scary. It's scary my people so quick to run and y'all believe in these crackers. I sit up here, I put defendant proof. Am I saying something out of my mouth? You can't go back and write down and check. Snap a picture, go check behind me. I ain't giving you these names saying, like in my, they tell me, if you go look behind me, that means you don't believe and you don't go to hell. Why wouldn't you? You need to know this, don't you? Because I'm going against stuff you've been told all your life, and some of it been from people you love, people you admire, people you have high admiration for. So for you to just get rid of it, you're going to need some proof. Then y'all said, now I'm going to show you what's noted in the scripture of truth, a mot. And there's none that's going to hold with me in these things. That's the danger part. Then y'all 11 to 13, I try to get y'all gone. Because I know I ain't done. But y'all don't know I can pick y'all spirit up, though, dude. I pick up a lot of these people. I pick y'all up and watch y'all and see. I know y'all think y'all be smart me. Y'all think y'all know something. Y'all go find a word, go look up stuff. Be sending stuff. I just want, sometimes I reply, just let y'all keep going. Because I know y'all will get all basic what you need to be looking for. And y'all think they be following doing what I'm doing. You're not doing what I'm doing. And I told you now, he that don't gather with me, you against me. You scattering. I be gathering. Y'all not gathering, y'all scattering. Some of y'all scatter damn brains. Pay attention. Get the gist of what I'm trying to get y'all to get. There are so many different things working against us. Y'all think y'all be getting something. You're not getting it. If your mind ain't getting more secluded on this and getting better informed on this and better tuned to teach this, what the hell are you getting in them woods? I can prove it right now. I can prove it right now. Ain't getting nothing from it. Absolutely nothing. I can prove it right now. How can I prove it? Who know how I can prove it? Huh? Speak up. What you say to what? Say what now? No. That's a question. So what you say? Do what? Say it again. Exactly right. I'm going to get in the pen. I'm going to see how much mountain going been working. Hell, you getting more out of the Colorado mountain. Going making cool as Bill. All this stuff will be done. I already know this stuff don't be a better than that. But in y'all mind, it be looking like it be helping y'all something. It don't help you with that. Y'all can't even do that with the information. And it's honest. What I said, gay y'all, this is so baby. Because we had a business. I had to go real baby. We were actually going to go a whole nother way. But you had to attack so many different things, explain stuff, and make sure people follow along, make sure people get a gist. Because that's a lot of information. But this really ain't nothing. It really ain't. It's so baby, it's ridiculous. But you had to do that. Now, I'm going to give Zach the pen. I'm going to see just how much Mountain Going been helping out. Let me finish this. I'm just see how much, just to show you, he can show me. He can prove me wrong now. Ain't that right? How many of y'all feel like I'm going to be proven wrong? Now, what did that tell you? That all these people's hands are down. I try to get these people, I did for my minutes, I try to tell y'all. If these folks really tune in and paid attention what I try to get them to see and really knew, man, at any time you get up here and do that. I can take a brand new baby, sit him in here, and he got any sense of one, I can take him and walk him through, I can explain everything I just told him. Anything he ain't got, I can explain. Matthias, baby, anything you sit up here and you won't question him, you can ask me about it, and I can prove it out. Anything you have, I ain't gonna say, what you have me for? You going to hell? That don't make no sense. I done had that fear tactic. That's fear tactic. Because you can't defend what you done said. You going, see, the Lord going to do something. See, hold on for a minute. The Lord is showing me somebody. Your spirit ain't right. Hell, I done heard all that scary stuff. True dirt done it. Anytime you did something different, I can give them pretty set. Got to watch that stuff. Folks set stuff different off. Now everybody watching saying, there ain't but one person. Hell, I got everybody watching me like I'm the devil. Yeah. Man, you to get up there and preach, I'll get to something before he call it. He quote, boom, I pick it up. Folks say, I'm watching you. I said, what? Them folks had me crazy. How you call that? Don't know you to read for I get stuck. Listen, them folks would tell him they didn't like it. They said, I don't like it. He begins stuff. You hadn't called it. How he knew how to get that? Where he get? I said, but like, what the hell? Now, of course, I can't say it now. Now I'm thinking, what the hell? How did I got some spirit on me? I'm just here. I'm with it. Anything you ought to be looking, bam, they own it. They don't like it. Hit for their tab, they told him they want me to stop it. And he said, listen, if I ain't called it, just don't get it. I said, but it felt like I had the devil. Because the man sitting up here, I'm bam, bam, I'm him. Hell, I had the devil. They said they ain't like it. I don't like it. I don't like it. He don't need to do it. You ain't called it. Look like he leading you. How the hell I'm leading him? He's talking, I'm right. I'm right with it. It be different. I just read something. He said, oh, okay, let me go where he going. Right. That's how bad people's minds are. Anytime you sit there and people see you growing and people see you doing something, they always trying to look to put it on you versus them looking at, now I put the stand on higher, they got to get their behind on track. Come on, read that, Daniel. Daniel, and you can think. Come on, Zach, on up here while they read this. Come up here, Zach. No, come on. Come on, get your opportunity to show me something. You ain't going to do it? You ain't going to bet a short time? Now, you think about all that mountain going. And I didn't do that. The badger want you to see something. I try to tell y'all something. This is what I look at. How many times we y'all see me give him do that? What, I give him about 10 minutes? 15? Probably minimum 2 hours. I put enough information up here. Y'all should easily have something anytime to jump up and just come up and say, pop, 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 pop. I'm with you, Pastor. What you've been saying is good. Let me come here and just add to the fundamentals of what you just put. You see what I'm saying? What I try to get y'all to do? Hell, y'all ready to run out here. Do something else, run, y'all eat, y'all sit around, y'all do this, ass up here, ass over here, ass everywhere. I've been trying to get y'all to focus and know. Do y'all understand how important this is for y'all to know this? My man, y'all really don't know. I'm gonna tell you why. People dying. I'm not the only person. Y'all understand people dying. People need to know this. People need to know what state they're in. I gotta dispel. This is not salvation, tell you about path. The reason I had to tell you that because I'm trying to get you to see how many other objects are working against you. When Shaul told you that spiritual wickedness, and what? You ain't going to believe where the monument's at. High places. Government. That's why you think they put the money high places. Everybody keep trying. They followed your book. It's going to come to pass in the last, I mean, that the mountain of Yahuwah is going to be established. Well, I need to put something over them. Huh? Over them. I got to get some above these people. These people got their own God. They got their own governments working. Right your whole time. They got all gods. They got goddesses working. Y'all hear me? They got so many things working. And you have no idea what this stuff is. Most of them heard Parthians. How many have never even heard of it? Hell, I thought they were talking about a python. I would have kept walking. Why would I be thinking about a goddess? I don't believe in a goddess. And I'm going to be sitting up in a place, and he done told you about sitting down, eating in the idol's temple. Your ass sitting down there eating. We don't even know. I'm just going. I got my family. We had to wash the monument. They got a I'm going to eat. Whole time I ain't realize I'm eating their food. They prepared. I'm sitting here eating in the idol temple. And the whole time I'm talking about, yeah, these Sunday worship going to hell. They so stupid. They don't even know. Whole time he done told me my people, they don't even consider. They don't even know. That's how serious this stuff is. You ask me sitting at the Washington Tower, sitting up inside these obelisks. That long been they got with the point. Those are obelisks. They got that stuff from Mizraim. The Greeks gave it to them. Why in the world these people keep building all Greek mythology? Because they believe the same thing. Your ass will be sitting right there, gardening, in it, working, eating it. Don't even know what you're doing. You get the top of Stone Mountain, they got rushed around, get chips and drink. Whole time you sitting here eating at a damn idol. And I told you don't eat in the idol's temple. But you don't know because you don't know these words. Nobody's identified or told you nothing. The whole time you praying to Jesus, going the wrong damn way and calling the wrong damn name. That's what get me so angry when I get up here and I get so mad. I needed them words. I get so upset. We sitting here down and we have no idea. We wouldn't have thought twice about going to no Lincoln Memorial somewhere sitting down. What you would have thought about you and your family just being in Washington, had an opportunity just sat down. Like they said, it's just something to look at. And y'all just been sitting the whole time. You wouldn't even know we've been sitting here eating in the idol's temple. What is an idol temple going to serve me? Thank you. What are they going to, they know what this is. What are they going to serve me? 100% organic? Cage-free, they're going to serve me stuff. They're going to feed the idol. This is going to be idol food because it's an idol temple. They didn't just go get Greek stuff for nothing. They're going to go build all Greek mythology. They just going to happen to build a pyramid and bury bury George Washington in it. What going to possess them to get a pyramid and bury him in it? What was just going to possess them to do all of a sudden? That's as far as they were going to go. Something struck them to build a pyramid over him. It's starting to build a pyramid because they know this is Afruka and they know that this is Mizraim over here. They were going to build the pyramid because they already got the other practices. That's why they give you the shrine of hat with the hair mood, the frizz, because they know exactly what's going on. That's why they show you their sword. Everything they know what they've been doing. And we've been sitting here like a damn fool trying to get them to, you know, these crackers will never tell you they know what I know. This stuff I'm putting there, I already know this stuff. That's why they question you. You say you're a Jew. That's interesting. They ask to see just how much do you know. They say, oh, okay. Crackers already know. They'll tell some of us. I'll be like, that's interesting because I've been looking at the days. When I'm saying myself, you're a Christian. Why would you be looking at the days? When I was a Christian, I ain't had no reason to care about nobody else's day. What the hell I care about a Ramadan? That's just my belief because Christianity don't teach you to research. Christianity teach you, don't let the devil come in and trick you. Don't it teach you that? It teach you don't think. It teach you keep your mind cold and don't investigate. What we're doing calls you to investigate and ask questions. What was here before you got that name? What was the religion of the people before you came on the scene? Nobody asked that. Now you're going to tell you. All right, church, y'all watch it. Then how about that? He did. Watch it. Devil using it. Son, I've been this way for 65 years, son. Me and Jesus been here a long time. I done fought many wars. Now the church, Pat, lying. How you know you weren't even there? And I know when a man going to hell. This fella tried me years ago like you asking me them questions, son. He ain't going to make it, church. Y'all watch him. Pray for him, though. He ain't going to make it. Why the hell we praying for him? I'm confused. But that, how many of y'all, church I came, they'll put that on you. If you ask questions, they put them to you. Be subject now. You finna be ostracized. They're gonna put eyes on you. Oh, he just questioned Pastor. Oh, he think he no more than I just asked a question. What was here before we started using Jesus? What religion was here before Christianity? Now the man say he don't believe in God, church. Y'all know where he ain't going to hell. And it's to scare everybody else to keep you from asking questions, to keep you from thinking, keep you from watching, looking. The reason why he told you that. And the reason why we fought that way, because we didn't know. Instead of him just telling the truth, brother, I don't know. This is all I know. This is all they told me. Instead of that, it's going to be the devil using him. He going to hell. Watch him. Church, we got to ostracize. These are the kind of people we got to get. Get out of here now. Because he's afraid of the truth. He's afraid of thinking himself and having to realize and say, I don't know. All I've been telling you is what other people have been telling me. That's what made me so mad. The fact that I had this type of mindset they gave me. working to run through a Bible to defend something that doesn't even need no defending, need to be destroyed. The stuff I spent more time trying to run and make sure I could defend something versus I should have been looking at. Too many errors are being spoken from the people telling it to me. There are too many errors. I remember one time, a pretty guy, he said, y'all think I talk bad. What y'all think Jesus would talk about? Walking around to my yay and thou. Everybody just laughing. They come in saying, why would they have been saying yay and thou? He convinced us that they would walk around, yay, Lord. This is medieval talking. That's what they call themselves, medieval. What did they tell you about these people? Their time period is called medieval, meaning the middle of evil. Then you know what, man? They'll have a castle. Go there and you can sit down and eat lunch. Y'all don't see no medieval thing? They tell you right over the damn thing, medieval. You know why he put all that stuff up there? Just making sure to make sure you ain't caught on. It's a test. Sometimes you just want to see how they really caught on. So then I watch you go in that medieval. I watch you go to the obelisk. I watch you go inside this statue. All this stuff are gods. I know you don't know what you think you know. I know you don't know what you think you know. That's why they put it out there. What he told you? Who put a trap out there and take it up until they done caught what they intended to get? Until they catch all of us. They're not going to take no Statue of Liberty down. They're not going to take down no obelisk. They're not going to take down no Lincoln Memorial. They're not going to take down no Washington because it's a trap. And it's set out there to catch who they intended to catch. That's why I got to educate y'all to keep you out of them hell hole, keep you off the top of that damn. I told y'all years ago, leave that damn mountain alone. I told y'all I did not want y'all back on that damn mountain. I didn't know why, but I just knew I was driven, don't go back on that mountain. These folks got another agenda. We ain't thinking about them the way you thinking. But when you get caught up there, you still going to wind up dying. Now, you done told me, done made me a watchman. Now, I warn you, and your ass go up there, you get took. That's your blood. Yep. Come on, finish that 11 and 30. Let y'all, I'm trying to let y'all go. Y'all all right today? Whew, listen.
Continue to verse 32.
At verse 32. Listen what happened.
And such as do wickedly against the covenant.
See that? And such as that do wickedly against the covenant. Listen what he's going to have.
Shall he corrupt by flatteries?
See that? That's what they're going to do. They can corrupt them through flattery. That's how you, Jennifer Hudson, all these people not innocent. They know they the devil. Listen.
But the people that do know their Elohim.
The people that know their Elohim, what happened?
Shall be strong and do exploits.
That's what I'm looking at. Now I'm getting stronger too. You know, they're getting in my mind to go more. They let me know I'm not stopping. Y'all hear me? If you know y'all Elohim, I don't know how y'all sitting here getting less. We probably be increasing. He said the people that do know their Elohim going to do exploits, they're going to do something about it. Why would I be telling you in Abraham, Abraham is a man he told him to walk before him. We didn't even go to the cell. He said walk before me and be blameless. Would you tell that to a man that's criminal? He told it to a man, you already been walking up keeping what I told you. Keep me, but you just murdered some people that took your IKEA and took the goods and you killed them and you brought it back. They'll tell you he was a murderous killer, a massacre man, whatever you want to call it. He was a man of Elohim who did exactly what he'd been instructed to do. We've been instructed to sit here and watch these. How you think they taking all of us the way they have? Because we've laid down submissive to these crackers. These crackers ain't never met us no good from the time we met them. They done taught a lie, destroyed us, took everything from us, disenfranchised, everything known wrong. They done raped us, robbed us, killed us, murdered us. And you still sit here passing these crackers. Still don't own a damn gun. What's wrong with you? Hell, you ready to kill me in a minute. Cracker come, first thing you do is lay on the damn ground and spread your legs. That's what you do for sex. He teach you sex positions. He been raping you ever since he damn met you. Then you ready to fight me to the death. Hell, I ain't took nothing from you. Listen.
And they that comprehend among the people.
That's what he said. And they that comprehend among the people. I can't imagine what they're going to do.
Shall instruct many.
No, I had to own live stream. I'm comprehending. How are these people going to know if we don't tell them? It's some honest people out there watching that's going to hear this. And they're going to come. Shaul told the same thing to his people in the 28th chapter of the book of Acts of Apostles, 28th verse. After he had boiled in his own house for 3 years, he told them. He said, be it known to y'all that salvation is going out to the Gentile and that they'll hear it. He got some people, what y'all won't do, he got some people watching me, they're going to do it. These people going to stand up and they're going to do what they need to do. Because he said, those that do comprehend, they're going to instruct many. And what's going to happen, son?
Yet they shall fall by the sword.
Let's be honest. Well, I know they're going to kill me. I ain't up here with no fool religion talking about, oh, they can't, the world can't do me no harm. These bastards kill me anytime they want. They poison my food. I had strychnine in, what, they had arsenic in my damn bloodline. They've been trying to kill me for a long time, like they did with Castro. Hell, after a while, they try to make my beard fall out. But at the end of the day, I ain't going to change for what I got to do. My life ain't worth living. I got to be no kiss-ass nigga. If I got to kiss Crackle's ass for me to keep living, I can die now. I'm allergic to ass kissing. Now, everybody else, you do it. Some of y'all don't mind a little ass in your mouth. I got a problem with it. Y'all hear me? I don't mind kicking some ass or even slapping some ass. I slap when I get home, Smitty, later. But anyway, I got a problem with kissing ass. That's that bottom line. I just keep it real as I can keep it with y'all. I'm not going to kiss these people's ass to be here. Y'all got me? I work just like these people do. I got a right to be here. I was here in my family with him before a white face showed up him. I mean, damn, I'm going to kiss their ass to keep me in him. Y'all hear me? Always you get up and go, hell, you shouldn't have never came. That the better come, not me get up and go. I'm trying to figure, why did you even come? Y'all hear me? See, we're here, we can exist. As long as you stay on your side of the fence, I stay on mine. I hear him great say, you stay your ass out my yard, and I stay out yours. We good. I hear him great radio. I'm going to stay in my yard, you stay in yours. Y'all hear me? We can exist as long as you leave me alone. But it's come taking, killing up, massacre, murder, and we leaving these kids without father. It's too much damage done in our homes, and we got to wake up as men. That's why we got to get him provide and set something up. I get on y'all, brother. You know why? I get on y'all to get him provide and set something up for people coming behind you. You know that? Somebody coming behind you. Just like the people that went before you called. You know what they kept saying? That servant Jacob behind me. They were making the way for somebody coming behind them. You hear me? That's all they kept saying. That servant Jacob behind me. You know what? Everybody that was saying he behind me, they had something in their hand, Dave. What you got to leave? Hell, nothing but your debt. Huh? Nothing but your damn disgrace. Nothing but your damn lies. What do you got to leave your family? Do y'all ever consider that somebody coming behind you? Every time they met Esau, they had some. Because you know what he looked at? Somebody behind me. And you know why I'm meeting him with some? I'm trying to make sure he don't get wiped out. Somebody come behind me, I'm trying to keep them from being wiped out. Hell, I can't do it with nothing. I'm wasting my time talking to y'all. They don't even think. He said, you won't even consider. Why don't we get out here? You will bust your ass for these people on a job, and you won't get out here and do nothing for the Dabarim to save your soul and set something up for your family coming behind you? I know what you do. Keep beating them. Make them learn all the master's, make them learn all the last master word, all master stuff. Hell, he can be small when he go to prison, or her. Or she can be on the street prostituting some damn man, ain't going to treat her worth nothing. I ain't raising my daughter to go out here and get no man to take care. I'm raising my daughter to grow up and teach her to well, teach them how to provide a half for themselves. You marry who you want. Don't marry nobody out of no damn reason, nobody taking care of you. They ain't no reason to marry nobody. You hear me? Same thing I'm teaching. I teach the women the same thing. You want to make your own way. That when you get a man, he see what he come to get. And you can't even step to their level. And you keep it moving. Tell him quick, keep it moving. You got a man ain't got no more drive than you. What the hell you going to do with him? You don't need nobody still on no titty. You need a man. That's what Moshe said, set a man over the congregation. Somebody that can go out before and somebody that can bring them in, that can lead them out. So the congregation of Yahuwah be not as sheep that don't have a raha. Now, if a man gonna hold a position, he got to know how to carry his home. It start in the home first. Hell, ain't nobody going to come to my dorm and tell my wife, go see who that is. Hell, that's my job. And I'm going packing. Hell, they could be the man. Put it down and get out their poise. And he runs and tell your friends. I ain't told y'all to shoot the mailman. Not yet. I'm just telling, hell, I'm look like sitting my wife to go and find out what's going on. That's my job. I'm the man. Anything going, that's the same thing we going to do. When Musa saw there was a burn on the mountain, saw the bush had burned out, hell, he told, won't you go out there and see what that is? It might be a stove or whatever. He told him, I'm going to go up and see what this is. Huh? Something burning, something. I need to go and see what it is. When Yahuwah heard what was going on down in the city, he said, oh, man, he said, I'm going to go out and investigate to see what's going on in the city. Isn't that right? When Musa was going to go get to that, he sent the men to spy the land out.
They brought back the witness of the land. They said, we were in their eyes at grasshoppers. Said the place was fenced up to Shamayim. But Caleb said, we be well able. Let us go up at once. We be well able. That's what I'm talking about, a man, and steal the people. He heard about how big them people were. He said, that don't move me. Let's go now. Hell, what are we waiting on? That's the kind of man you can go with. You know what Yahuwah said about him? He said, all those people that didn't believe me, they ain't getting there. Save for Caleb. They have wholly followed me. They didn't let none of their you think these folks, let me tell you something. As a natural man, yes, there's some fear. I would not tell you no fear, I'd be lying. Yeah, there's some fear. I want to live, I don't want to die. But what good is living if you got to live like a lower domesticated animal? Huh? What the purpose of living? If all my best I can do is be the best slave this Crocker ever had, wait on this Crocker to give me some paper, a certificate, a damn trophy, a plaque, and I'd be kissing his ass all the way to the den. That's why he buried you with your face. Bury me with my face buried going down. That way when y'all come by, y'all white folk kiss my ass. Because I ain't kissing yours. I'm irritated. It'll take for the fact we done sit here everything. We sitting in the room again before we dismiss. Pull out that parking lot. You can go left or right. You can go to that hotel if you want to. And one of them crackers in that police car pull your ass over. It's just all about how he feel. You can be another YouTube video. And that don't even bother you. Not only you and your kid in the car with you. Hell, it could be one of them things where he just feel like, man, you know what I'm saying, like a bowling pin. I hit the one in the middle and all the rest of them come down. And then let's just be honest. What are we going to do? Let's just use you for hypothetical. Just hypothetical battle. They shoot battery in going home. What are we going to do? He thought she was somebody else and shoot the wrong person. What are we going to do? Hell, go get a sign and mud. Tell me I ain't going to let anybody turn me around. That's an insult. Your ass need to turn around because you're going the wrong way. Let's just be honest. What can we offer our people? That's what made me so angry with us. What can we do? Send letters, go to Crackers and ask Crackers to call the DA, see who know the judge, try to get Al or get one of Jesse them to come out. Hell, they be dead. What can we do? What would Abraham have done? Abraham would have took a trained servant and he'd have slew every one of them bastards. That's just being honest. This is what I don't get and why I'm so irritated. Why are we so passive when we're not the criminals? Why are we the people being victimized, being gunned down when we're not the criminals? How do we get to an estate to where these people can kill us at will with video? That was always incredible. They tell you all the time, video. If I'm in the store stealing, they're going to say, son, we got you on tape. If I'm in the parking lot stealing cars on the camera, they're going to say, son, I can't tell that. He said, son, you on tape. Hell, I got a police getting out of this car. Hell, I got the beginning of his day when he went to Dunkin' Donut and the Krispy Kreme. Hell, he done came, rolled around and raped some women, then came and hopped there and shot and killed Eric. Hell, I got some white folks saying, well, what happened before he got the Krispy Kreme? All I need to see him coming up, what did Eric do, what did he do, what transpired right here is what I'm looking at. This is going to be my deciding fact on what happened. You got to stop him, pull him over. This man had no weapon. Hell, you shot him, you killed him. That's all I need to see. We living in a system now where these people are killing us and we got these no good ass-kissing preachers telling us about praying to Jesus, who is the name of an earth pig and a damn slave ship. They telling us to get rid of guns and these crackers getting more guns. The FBI reporting they can't even process all these damn gun permits these people getting. Your ass up here praying, giving away guns for a damn $50 turkey. Ain't it but a damn buzzard in plastic? What am I supposed to do? My people getting killed. How long before it's just like musical chairs. How long before they pull your chair, right? How long before they get your chair or your chair? How long before your chair or my chair come? See, I'd be a fool to keep sitting here and not talking about, I can play the fool if I want to. It's just a matter of time for one of these crackers to pull one of us over and our ass is laid out. Unless unless we organize, unless we strategize, unless we start to get our own. We'll build our own community. We get our own businesses. We cut away from their voting. Let these bastards have this junk. It ain't never meant us no good since we've been going. These crackers done lied about polls. These crackers give you numbers at where you can't believe nothing they said. Hell, they hated Obama. Now Obama leave with a 7-8% approval rate. How the hell he got a 7-8% rate and you got over 900 damn more hate organizations for black that came in the year he came? Over 900 new hate organizations were formed of white folks against you when he took office. Over 900. That's when he took office. How many more they got? He can't even say nothing to the damn police. Little black ass just tried to go and join a golf club up there. Them crackers just told him, don't want it. Oh, his little black ass thought he was finna join that golf course up there. They told him, not here. Crackers don't care nothing about it. Rightfully, I don't want your ass here either. Hell, I go get me a mask and I'm like Clayton Beasley. I'm sick of him. These folks have done nothing for but lie to us. They are killing us every day and we sitting here passive. Nobody care about us. The Negro leaders have left us. These lying preachers have keep invoking us, keep us enslaved to this same system that's killing us. Now you use your head and look at your city. You look at your parents, look at your situation. You look at your school system. You look at your neighborhoods if I'm lying. Or where these crackers hire you when they do, they ain't got enough of their own in there. And you'll never get the same ranking one of them whites get. Hell, you can get in the military, you ain't nothing. The bad black general equivalent to a damn buck private cracker. Go run your mouth to one of them little sergeant crackers and see what happened to your, see don't you get some damn stripe pulled off your jacket. Go and piss out one of them wrong white boys. You'll find out exactly how much they care about them stripes on your jacket. These folks know I'm telling the truth. Ain't no nigga getting no same ability no cracker got with that jacket. Them stars ain't nothing but some damn little plastic little tinket when it come down to you wearing it. It means someone a cracker got it on. Quit making a fool out yourself for these people. I'm sick of it. I done said a lot. One or two things again. Either I lied or I told the truth. If I lied, if I was y'all, wouldn't fool with me. But you know the system lying that done told you what they told you and trained the way they trained you. You know you less equivalent to these people. You know these people don't think of you the same way they think of their own people. And rightfully so when you look at it. Because you bought into the hype of their lies. You let these people sit here and manipulate you enough that you thought less of yourself. You felt like everything bad in life should happen to you and only you, like Dave Chappelle told you. Huh? Yeah, you should be rewarded for the things you've done wrong. Like anybody, I believe in restitution. I've done wrong and I should reap for the wrong I've done because the book said they had no respect to person. But I'm looking at him too. When is he ever going to be recompensed for his wrong? Huh? I'm going to let the criminal give his own sentence. I'm going to let the person that raped me, robbed me, murdered me and my family come up with his own convictions. How is that going to happen? If he had convictions, he would have never done it. I can't look at this man the same way and sit here and lie to myself. I got to tell myself the truth. He ain't in no moral position to judge me. He ain't got nobody among his people he got that can sit down and judge me. Not rightfully. Y'all got me? Because the first thing I do is just like Yahusha told him. You get one of your crackers without sin to catch the first stone. And that'll leave me blameless again. Y'all hear me? And they can find something I still be blameless. Too much blood on the hand. Too much guilt. And that's why I try to get y'all brethren as men to get on your feet, to establish and have y'all own. Y'all will walk away from creation, and y'all will go right back to comfortable in the Canada. Y'all will go back to what's comfortable. As long as a man give me a check, as long as I got something, and I count that as something. There's no way I'm finna sit here and give up trying to make my own where I can build, I can put myself in the formula and have my own. I don't know how y'all do it. Y'all, brother, y'all scare me. Y'all scare me. Y'all love a job. For what? What is a job? What's a job? I'll let y'all go. You know who got me really looking at a job? James Evan. How many times y'all remember when JJ was going to school and they asked him about trying to get him to stay in 11th grade? And the principal tried to get him, they were going to social promote him. He said, Mr. Evan, he said, your son can go ahead to 12th grade And he graduated. He got a gun. He said, a job? Hell, I got a job. I got two. He said, I want my John's son to have a future. You didn't hear that. Jane looked at this. He had a job, and he was living in the project with his family. So I want my son to get out of school so he can get a job, so he can live in the project. He said, I want my son to have a future. See, that's different than what you're looking at. Most of y'all got jobs. They don't have futures. Huh? You just got a lifelong commitment to slavery. You got a lifelong commitment to impoverishment. You got to wait on that cracker to decide when he's going to give you a dime, 15 cents, a quarter, hell, and he give you that when he finna take something else up. So now you say, uh-oh, I got a quarter, but then my benefit went up. He don't see rumpus still skin. So I didn't give you nothing. If I gave it to you, then I told you something else. Well, so I didn't give you nothing. But in your mind, you thinking you got something. And you thinking it's security because this cracker cutting you something. I've been taught y'all people. You don't need jobs. You're only there to infiltrate. When we were slaves, you learned how to do cold. You don't tell them everything you know. You own that job, and you always looking for escape routes. I know the master, he thinking, you good, boy. You know what? I want you to go with me today. I'm going to go pick up some stuff from the store. When I'm going, I'm watching where I'm going. He going to take me up in his other office. I got to look at how I got him. He put me on the elevator, hit something, but we went on the floor. I'm watching where his hand went, right about there. I'm always looking for an escape route, because I got to look at it as a slave. And you got to be a slave where you ain't comfortable. If you there, you're only there to infiltrate so you can get what you can get so you can get out. Y'all ass ain't got no been in here loving these crackers. How you love being a slave? How can you formulate and create from where you at? I call Kenneth. Can you formulate and create from where you at? The answer, he don't know. This is what I want y'all to learn before I let y'all go. Anything you're doing need to have purpose. Anything. If I'm there, it's for a purpose. How many of y'all ever watched this movie? Not you, movies a lot of times. Law by Citizens. Y'all remember here why he got raped? And his daughter and got killed? Beautiful. And then remember they captured the guy that did it? And they went to court? And they got him to take a plea and did a plea with these men and gave them less time they should have got because Jamie Foxx didn't want to go to court and he didn't want to get all that. He didn't want to take a chance at losing and mess up his record. He said, at least you'd have went. At least you'd have gave an opportunity versus you just gave in and done it. He allowed them to lock him up. And one of his other spies came and talked to the guy and told him. He said, well, we got him in lockdown. He said, he ain't nowhere he don't want to be. He said, wherever you got him at is where he wanted to be. He set them up to put him in solitary. That way he could break out at night and he can go and kill all those people. But he's been in population. There's no way to sneak out. He made them put him in solitary, which would put him by himself, and they wouldn't check on him, and he could sneak out and he can go and kill each one of them people he felt like were responsible for them people getting off. And he told him, wherever he's at is where he wanted to be. Y'all got me? Yahusha told you that. That where I, there you may be also. Yahusha wouldn't know where he didn't want to be. It looked like they took him and they killed him. He told you, didn't nobody take my life. He said, I lay it down. It looked like somebody forced something on him. I assure you, he ain't going to know where he didn't want to go. How the hell you send these jobs somewhere you don't want to be? Which means you have no strategic planning. You just kind of go with the wind. Going with the wind. There's no future behind what you're doing. Why are you doing it? Y'all got me? You got to learn how to let these crackers move, and you got to learn how to manipulate the system to get the way you're trying to go. That's what he did. He knew enough of the law to know how these people were acting, what they would do. He knew where they were going to put it because he couldn't do it himself. But I know enough to make you do what I wouldn't do. And it'll put me where I need to be. How y'all ain't got this sense? How the hell y'all got the sense to just sit on these jobs and your ass just keep getting on going to work and just waiting to get fired? Learn how to put yourself, you have to learn how to strategically put yourself in a position that will allow you to elevate. Y'all don't do that. You just sit in a trap situation. That scares me. And then he told you to let this, I can't remember, be in, which were also in him. When your mind going to get right? When y'all mind going to get right? How y'all take it? Y'all do stuff. Y'all scare me. How y'all so comfortable with people just giving you a piece of something, a little something? Versus, if I can do this for somebody, this is just using an illustration. Chris, driving your truck. If I can drive his truck in real life, Chris got a truck, I'm driving Chris' truck, and Chris got a truck. Chris ain't know nothing about no truck. He got a truck, and I'm driving Chris' truck. Chris can pay me from this truck. Hell, I drive the truck, and I made money, and then Chris made money. Hell, what if I keep doing this and save my money and buy my own damn truck? Now I get all the money myself. Hell no, let me go take a job, let a cracker pay me, hell, bits and pieces, and I can sit around and I can help stack up lies on the shelf. What's my strategy? I'm just using you because I'm showing y'all how y'all think. Y'all scary. Y'all are scary in here to me. Why would I be afraid to get out here and to do for myself? I'm doing something for this man, he's going to pay me. He's making money. I need to learn how to get my own library, how I can stack up my own books, I can make my own money. Because if you can pay me for doing it, I need to learn how you making money. Me putting up moving books, how exactly do you get paid? I need to learn that versus learning how to keep putting up some damn books. Hell, I don't know. It's just me. Y'all don't think. And you still trapped. They'll keep a black man here. Don't y'all know the job of these people? They will put a woman over him. For their little black, because it's always dumb to keep a black man down. Just keep him, just like they did with Jane. They tried to show you a lot of stuff. There. One time they were going to set Florida up. One time James and her, he went down for a job and they gave Florida the job. Who remember that episode? They've been showing you all the time. She went down there with him. He said, baby, come on down here. Maybe they're supposed to get me a job. Maybe I can get you one of them little jobs, you know, like secretary. Hell, he got down there. They hired her and not him. Because the system always been set up to put the woman over the man. Hell, y'all come. It don't matter. As long as I got something, though. Y'all guys, y'all, Hell, y'all see me on the new Robin before I sound Lady Crack, just give me something. I can't take it. I'm being honest, I can't do it. I'm like Shang Tsung. I go out at night and I take it from him. I tell him flat, I'm going to take it. Don't put it in my face, I'm going to take it. All right. Just trying to tell you, because you know, it makes no sense. Your ability, they've taught you that your drive has always been negative. Me wanted to have, hell, he want to have. Why you think he have wars and he take over countries and kill people? Because his desire to have and take. I have a desire to exist. And my desire to exist don't tell me to exist off no damn library book. Off no damn kibbles and bits. I ain't no dog. I'm a man. And God, being a man, people looking at me. I got to get here and make a man's wage. When I eat, I want a man's meal. I don't want no damn kid meal. I don't eat no Lunchable.
That's right.
I'm a man. I'm going to care of myself and such. I'm going to work. I'm going to earn it, sir, as a man. I'm teaching y'all the same thing. Quit sitting around being passive. You somewhere you want to formulate while you there. If you're going to be in the library, you're going to learn how to own the library. All these lies mine now. Go down aisle 16, row A. That's my lie. Y'all hear me? That's what we got to do. Stop sitting around waiting on people to do stuff for y'all and give y'all stuff. Stop doing what's always comfortable for you. That's why I work out. A lot of stuff I do here, it's not comfortable for me. But now I got to look at life. Life ain't about being comfortable. Sometimes you got to do some things that are stressful to get you into a comfortable position. Let's say if I stood up here like this for 6 hours, it's going to be comfortable? What's going to probably happen for 6 hours? Oh, I'm going to get tired. What if I put some nails in my hand and keep them from falling? They're going to be comfortable? But then I got to look at after a while, where it's going to put me at. See, I got to look at the bigger picture. You don't think like that. You just got to start what you can't do. Well, if I can get this done, I can work to get to where I can be comfortable. You got me? That's how you had to look at it. You're doing stuff that's not comfortable or conducive to a real future. It ain't even yelling you nothing. That I don't get. I can follow Yahushua because I can see, okay, I'm with you. All of this was done to get you to where you're at now. He said, I overcame, and I sat down with my Abba. So it was a purpose. What is your purpose when you're doing something? Okay, I'm boring y'all. Do y'all got me? What is your purpose? Are you just working to work that something's going to happen? I'm scared. Everything I'm doing, Y'all got me? Ain't nowhere I don't want to be. Y'all got me? Ain't gonna let nobody put me nowhere I don't want to be. It's got to be strategic moves. You got to have an alternative. Y'all got me? You got, because the people got you, got one. You can either work or you can go to jail. Those are your two alternatives. Because you don't have no other alternative. You never thought of one. As long as this cracker lets you be free, you're on a job, you're still in prison. Because you're getting prison pay. You're getting prison treatment. You come when I tell you to come and you leave when I tell you to go. And you got to earn credits if you get off early. You got to earn credits to be able to get paid when you get off. So you're still in a prison system. Don't think because no bars around you got you incarcerated. You're incarcerated in your mind. All that shit I do is just think. If I'm wrong, if I was you, and you know that I willfully sat here and led you wrong, don't ever watch me again. Don't ever listen to nothing else I say. But if you know I told you the truth, I should see you here this Wednesday night. That's good.